Wrestling is a presentation of the National Hockey League.
35 pounds of silver gets raised easily, but winning the Stanley Cup is hard. In Chicago, the Blackhawks already went through the pain and the celebration in their two victories. High scoring in Game 1 Saturday. 11 total goals. The last by Thomas Kopetsky made it 6-5. Low scoring Monday. Marian Hossa one, an ex-Flyer the other. Philadelphia, the orange and black team with the Halloween mean streak. Game 3 on Versus. They've worn the orange in Philadelphia to support the team for 43 years. First at the Spectrum and then at Wachovia Center. They have been told on public address they're the most intimidating fans in the National Hockey League.
You thought it was easy in Chicago, but now you're here. The hair man's here. The Flyer fans are here. You're going down. You are going down here in Philadelphia.
I won't argue right now. Welcome to the Geico Stanley Cup Final pregame report. Game 3, best of 7. The Blackhawks up 2-0, but we're in Philadelphia this time. As if you had any question about that. Good evening, everyone. Along with Eddie Olchek, Carissa Thompson, Bob Harwood, in just a moment, I'm Mike Emrick. So we know the fans are intimidating, but is the Philadelphia offense intimidating?
Well, I think it can be, Daka. That is the greatest strength of the Philadelphia Flyers. Their depth up front, and it all starts with their active defensemen. But I think their big line is on the verge of really starting something big. Simon Gagné, Mike Richards, and Jeff Carter. 20 shots in the series between the three of them, and they come up a great third period. You see the numbers so far, not a lot going on, but a tremendous third period. And with Mike Richards and Jeff Carter, two guys that are instrumental in faceoffs, puck possession, you dictate what's going on. 36 of the 71 faceoffs in game two were taken by those two guys.
Impressive. And so is the 10-year pro named Simon Gagné, who spoke just moments ago with Carissa Thompson.
Thank you, Doc. Simon, your D has been effective in shutting down their top line. That being said, your line only has one goal in the last two games. How do you get this thing going tonight?
We need to get better, that's for sure. I thought at the last game, especially in the third period, we start to create a little bit more offensively, and that's the type of hockey your line have to play, and hopefully we could get it more than one goal tonight.
What changed? Because you guys seem to hit your stride. You got that forecheck going, you got pucks in deep. What changed for you?
You know what, we just start to play our game, maybe play more relaxed, you know. I don't want to say we were nervous, but you know what, you try to see what the other team's going to do and stuff like that. And but I know when it was 2-0, we had no choice, and that's where you play your best hockey. You go out there, you don't think, and that's where we're in. And hopefully tonight, be back in Philly in front of your fans, we're going to definitely play a better game.
Right where you want to be. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thanks.
Doc, let's send it back to you.
Gagné, Richards, and Carter did warm up together before the game tonight. If there's another Flyer forward who could blow this thing wide open, who is it?
I think we're looking at a future superstar in the National Hockey League, and his name is 22-year-old Claude Giroux. He had 8 goals coming in the Stanley Cup Final. The Flyers have played 17 games. He has not had a goal in the series so far. No shots on goal in game 2. You see the skill level, you see the ability. When you talk about a guy on the verge of breaking out, he's been standing around a lot, not getting involved, but he had his best shift of the Stanley Cup Final, Doc, in that third period. We heard Simon Gagné talking about he got available, he won races, he has that ability. Talk about the strength, the depth of the forwards, that guy is Claude Giroux.
This crowd is getting louder by the moment. You can hear it too. It's a raucous atmosphere here. Is there one Blackhawk who can shut him up?
Well, it's the most important position in all of sport, and that's goaltender Antti Niemi. He only saw 3 shots in period 1 and game 2, and then he saw 30 in the last 2 periods. He was sensational. I really believe, Doc, that Antti Niemi won the game for the Blackhawks in the second period. He looks real comfortable. He looks collected and not giving up a lot of rebounds.
His numbers are all very small. Unfortunate for the Blackhawks, some of theirs are too in scoring. Patrick Kane, Jonathan Toews, they're hungry. A challenge for Chris Pronger and Kimmo Timonen.
The Stanley Cup Final on Versus is presented by Geico, proud sponsor of the NHL.
Welcome back to the Geico Stanley Cup Final pregame report. As the noise gets louder, we get closer to hearing God Bless America, among other things, the excitement leading up to game number three here. The Chicago Blackhawks, an extremely talented team, but pick somebody that you've been really impressed with.
How much time do we have? Great depth, a lot of young players, but I'm going to go one of their veteran guys who was brought in for a specific reason to bring that experience and that depth. Marian Hossa, back-to-back-to-back Stanley Cup Finals. But go back to the first goal of the game the other night. Lots of great things happening. All five players on the ice touch the puck. Brent Seabrook's going to move this puck D to D. And then Patrick Sharp comes in and finds a soft little area in the coverage of the Philadelphia Flyers. And then the aerials, Marian Hossa, the eventual goal scorer. Great pass here by Duncan Keith. Mike Richards, a step slow. Sharp finds a soft little area. A rebound in front. Troy Brower there. And Marian Hossa is able to elevate and score his third goal of the playoffs. I talked to Hossa. He told me this morning, Doc, the first 10 minutes are crucial. They want to weather this storm. And this storm looks orange in behind us.
It does. He's been in the final for three straight years. Now, let's hear from this guy. He spoke with Bob Harwood.
Doc, thank you very much. Marian, 15 different Blackhawks have scored in the playoffs. What is it about the depth and the ability on this team that's allowed you guys to be so broad in terms of scoring?
Well, I think during the whole season it's been like that. And obviously, you know, top guys got a lot more goals, but still lots of guys can score on this team, which is positive, especially in the playoffs. And right now it's paying off.
Your team-wide defense is going to be challenged tonight. Philadelphia's got desperation and they're at home. Where are you most concerned about how they're going to attack you? Where do you have to button things down?
Well, the first 5 to 10 minutes, we have to be smart with the puck, try to play the most in their zone and keep the thing simple, because it's going to be lots of pressure on us, and I'm sure the crowd is going to be into it, and we have to be really smart in the first 5 minutes.
Marian, thanks a lot.
Thank you very much.
Doc, back to you.
Hossa, his line mate Patrick Sharp and Troy Brower going up against the Flyers netminder Michael Layton. Closer to the faceoff. We'll be right back. The Philadelphia Flyers have played 8 home games. They have won 7 of them. They are on the ice here at Wachovia Center. There is no team of recent vintage that has won 7 straight road games. This is the most recent now, the Chicago Blackhawks carrying that streak onto the ice here in South Philadelphia. Just as in Chicago, in Philadelphia, they have traditions near the start of the game. Let's listen to Lou Nolan.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, please welcome the number one ranked anthem, Mr. NHL librarian Lauren Hart, and the great Kate Smith with this evening's performance of God Bless America.
Stand beside.
My goodness. Wow. They have done this for 10 straight games. This is the 11th. That particular God Bless America that you saw. Let's take a look at tonight's netminders with the Miller Lite Taste Greatness starting goaltenders. Antti Niemi in the league has 14 wins. No one has more. That's the most ever by a Hawks goalie. Michael Layton is first in save percentage, first in shutouts, first in goals against. No changes in either lineup. Nicholas Hjalmarsson and Brian Campbell start on defense. Chris Versteeg, Dave Bolin, Thomas Kopetsky up front. Chris Pronger and Matt Carl, no surprise, on defense. Scotty Hartnell, Billy Leno, and Danny Briere are up front for the start of the game. Dan O'Halloran and Bill McCreary are the referees in the game tonight. Bill McCreary sets a record for final series appearances with this, breaking the record set by Phil Chadwick. Ahead with this is Butlin, and off a quick change by the Blackhawks, a shot tipped out of play by his friend Chris Prong.
We talk about a quick change right off the bat, Doc. Not even about 3 seconds in, Thomas Kopetsky, who started with Dave Bolin on his line, the checking line for Joel Quenneville, came right off the ice, and then Dustin Butlin jumped down. So again, line matching. Joel Quenneville, he chases the match. And something to keep an eye on.
Peter Laviolette is the coach of the home team who gets last change. If you respond every time, then he controls your bench, the visiting coach. So that's why they don't respond all the time. Thrown back in, and that went off of Taves. Flicked off the back of the goal and was fed around in front. Kane couldn't come up with it, but it's played safely back off by Brent Seabrook and came in front for the grab and the hold by Layton. Tonight's Pizza Hut favorite matchup.
Well, we saw it in the first 30 seconds of this game. Big Dustin Butlin of the Chicago Blackhawks and big Chris Pronger of the Philadelphia Flyers. Not only battling up ice, but right in front of Michael Layton. And one thing to take a look for, Doc, we just saw it. The puck takes some crazy bounces off the stanchions in behind the goaltenders here. So something to keep an eye on. If you're Antti Niemi, who doesn't know his building and has never played in here, and Michael Layton knows him well, if the puck's in the glass, you have to stay at home. You cannot leave the crease because of the crazy caroms.
Mike Richards saw that one fed away, laid back out again. Richards is out there now with Daniel Carcillo and Claude Giroux. And here's Giroux, that X factor that Eddie Olczyk mentioned. Carcillo tried to play further. Coming along now is Aaron Asham. Boy, you talk about fire wagon changes. We're getting them here early again. Tipped by Hossa. Carried ahead by Brouwer. Picks up Hendry and couldn't get the pass across. Good back-checking job done there, but it's fiddled away from Carcillo by Hossa.
And a real good active stick there by Chris Pronger on Troy Brouwer. Looked like you had something going, Chicago. Two-on-one with Jordan Hendry. The defenseman jumping in, but the good active stick there by Pronger.
John Madden, Ben Eager, and Adam Burrish are out for the Blackhawks. This is booted along by Darryl Powell. After it is Blair Betts. Fourth liner is out there now. Is turning with this is Ian LaPerriere. LaPerriere saw it go to Betts, and a backhander ricocheted right back to him off Niemi. Then Hjalmarsson led one that went all the way back down. No icing on this play. Quite a bit of activity between Ben Eager and Lucas Krajicek. Nudged across, and Eager, who scored the winning goal last game, has it again, and a shot went wide from the ex-flyer. Jab back along, and a good thump put into Campbell by Darryl Powell. Betts steering traffic and then takes the puck and lays it ahead. Here's Powell trying to get by. Wedged off by Campbell, and he spun it on goal off the stick of Niemi.
Great effort there by Darryl Powell. And a good recovery there by Campbell, because it looked like Powell was going to get inside position, but the speed of Campbell denied him. He was able to shield Campbell off and get a good shot on Antti Niemi.
More quick changes. Pronger gave on to Carl. Thrown back up by Gagne. Across to Carter. He's out there with Richards. And back in deep it goes. Duncan, Keith, and Brent Seabrook are there as a shot had to be knocked to the side of the net. And because there was a little extra work being done, a crowd is gathered. Seabrook and Keith were out there as Joel Quenneville, the visiting coach, wants against the big line for Philadelphia.
Oh, there's a nice little pass there by Blair Betts. But there's the speed of Campbell. Watch what Powell does. He shields him off in all in one motion. Almost a spinorama type play there by Darryl Powell. And look at Antti Niemi down early, taking away the bottom of the net. And Dustin Byfuglien on Jeff Carter, getting a piece of him right before that whistle came.
Leno on the draw with David Bolin. Nudged by Seabrook, rattled around, and Kopetsky unable to play it out. Reverses and nearly gave it up, but nearly the operative word as it's Bolin laying it along. Seabrook bashed into there. Kept along now by Briere and flipped in front. Knife right back by Keith, then by Seabrook off Briere's toss. And the Blackhawks can start it ahead, but a pass too far for Christopher Steeve. Kimmo Tiimonen laid it across. Laid right back in again by Leno, and it careened over for Duncan Keith. Michigan State product able to feed it through to David Bolin. Bolin had it knocked away and had to reverse, and then eventually comes up with it. That hawkish forecheck that caused trouble from the Flyers for New Jersey, as well as for Boston and Montreal, working here until now. It's brought in by Kane. Kane, a shot turned aside by Layton. Corralled by Taves. He and Kane are out there with big Dustin Byfuglien. Byfuglien with an assist in this series in two prior games. Kane and Taves are so far empty. Laid across now for Pronger, and then sent back ahead for the carry that was stifled very quickly off of Aaron Asham by Kane.
Dangerous play there by Matt Carl, docking in a backhand pass. I don't think he saw that somebody was on Pronger's tail there.
Boy, Taves with some nice work here, and then he jabbed it around, took quite a hit from Pronger. Puck back to Jalmerson, around to Byfuglien. Fed one for Kane. Kane spun it in front. It careened back to Brent Sopel. Sopel played it safely off the boards. Jabbed away by Pronger, pinching along as Jalmerson. Flipped one along that careened off Kane, went down to the ice, and stepping with it is Carl. Then Asham, then across for Carcillo to return. Asham with a head of steam and a drive, and that blocked right down by Jalmerson. Spinning is Giroux, and hit shot knocked down in front. Unable to get a good shot away, Asham. Giroux slugged another one that is kneelingly blocked and played back along by Sopel.
A nice little play there by Daniel Carcillo in the neutral zone. Give and go with Aaron Asham.
Brent Sopel gave it on to Jalmerson. Led it ahead for Sharp, but tapped back in by Gagne, though at least one Flyer was already in the zone. So offside is called.
You mentioned about lots of hits going on in this Stanley Cup final. Jonathan Toews with nice moves through the neutral zone, and then Pronger, as Toews makes contact with that puck, chipping it up the wall. Pronger gets the shoulder into the captain of the Blackhawks, Toews. Toews goes down. And the one thing I'm noticing, Doc, is that Patrick Kane isn't getting stuck on the right side. He's a left-handed shot. He plays the right wing. We've seen him come up the left-wing boards a few times now. In the first two games of the final, he's been coming out a lot of those situations when they've had the puck. He's challenged up the right side where Matt Carl is. It's like Kane's trying to challenge over on Pronger's side.
A shot by Carter rattled wide. One by Tiimonen is blocked around in front. Came back for a hurried shot that went wide from Carter again. Played by Gagne. Had it knifed away by Bolin and fed back ahead for the outlet pass that is just cut by Carter and again back in. Much of the play has been in the end of the ice you're watching right now. Duncan Keith leading the Blackhawks in ice time and the series in block shots. Eight block shots coming into this game for him in two games. Now here's Hossa's shot that's blocked off by Layton and picked up by Danny Briere. On it comes now to Hartnell. He's got Leno with him. Denied by Jalmerson, flipped along by Sharp, kept by Pronger, handed to Carl. Carl with a shot that is kicked aside by Brian Campbell. Banked right back to Carl again, and that one went off the stick of Hartnell. Jalmerson is run into by Hartnell. Puck around behind, back pass by Briere failed, and Campbell is able to play it on now to Brouwer. Roy Brouwer brings it back ahead. 24 years of age, 3 days from now. Part of the great youth movement in Chicago and a highly skilled one. It is Sopel again. The veteran experience of Brent Sopel. He's able to lead it ahead, and the pass was deflected on to be played back in by Adam Burrish. Right there comes John Madden as well. The rollicking fourth line out there for Chicago. Same deal here. Burrish had a shot. stifled there, and a good job done defensively by Claude Giroux, who leads it offensively for the Flyers. Dishes off now. Carcello a shot. Another one knocked down in front, laid back to the boards, and settled down by Madden. Got it ahead to Burrish, and Burrish is able to play it gently back in and around into the trapezoid, where it is handled and thrown into some traffic. So it careened back for Seabrook's shot, knocked down in front. Layton trying to cover, still trying to cover, and the puck popped off the frame and is played back along by the Flyers, but not out. A surge from Chicago now.
Great keep in there by Duncan Keith.
This is LaPerriere getting it to the safety of center. Carcello sent it the other way. Shift change for the Flyers. Moving back up, Brent Seabrook crisply across to Patrick Kane. Kane threw one in front, and it's chapped away with a goal stick held by Layton. Outletted by LaPerriere, carried on by Powell. Breathless pace, thrown in front, and another block by the Blackhawks. And moving back up ice with it and controlling on out further. Shoving across was Taves. Bufflin drops. Taves with it. And his shot is knocked down. Campbell able to recover. Campbell sent it around behind. It went off of Pronger and then went off of Carl. Carl able to bang it right back in again. And Pronger takes once more. And back out and off of Powell. Given across now to Jalmerson. Another drive wide of Layton in the cage. Another drive, and that one ricocheted all around and has to be played by Tiemannin. Deflected on back, and it is read there by Keith, handed on to Seabrook. The Blackhawks in a surge right now. Neither team getting a lot of scoring chances, but are having puck possession in the other team's end of the ice.
And a big hit by Scott Hartnell on Brent Seabrook in the neutral zone once Seabrook got that pass from his partner Duncan Keith in the neutral zone. Fever pitch right now, Doc.
This is great. Brought ahead by Leno. Leno tried to slide one in front, denied by Sokol. Just attack met by resistance. Then it came back out for a feed across. Oh, and Gagné's shot was off the stick of Niemi and wide. Held on back by Pronger. Dealt around behind. It's allowed to go to Danny Briere. Flipped it on further off Gagné. Knife three, and it can be controlled by the Blackhawks and sent off the boards. Kicked along by Carl. Taken by Briere. Briere run off, though, by Patrick Sharp. And it's Henry chipping it along. Sharp able to deflect it out to center. 4 minutes without a whistle to stop play. Just fine. Gagné plays it around, and Carter put it off the back of the cage. Our sponsors may not see it that way. Versteeg laid it across, and it's Poland retrieving it there and banging it back in. Well, I think they'll like it. They like the action. They'll get their chance. Bouncer came around, and it's hacked away to the corner board. Here's Seabrook with it, and a shot is turned aside by one of the skates in front, not that of Layton. Carried back on by the Flyers on the attack, and a good bump there by Seabrook, and an offside is called on the play. They got Carcello, not as much as they wanted. Close call at the front. The old Flyer almost generated a scoring play. Taves off the post.
We are scoreless in Philadelphia. He's barely 29, but he's been a frequent Flyer for a long time. Michael Layton has played games for 9 pro teams, been traded twice, and the other note, waived 4 times. That's a tough one. When he came to Philadelphia during their worst period of goaltender injuries this season, the coaches said, the door is wide open here. Don't worry about results right away. Just get into a starting goaltender rhythm. And goalie coach Jeff Reese knew what he was talking about in terms of a lot of movement. He himself, as a goaltender, 8 pro cities in 12 seasons, he knew what to say to a traveling man, fellas.
Jeff Reese has been pretty busy, too. If we were to document all of the changes in the Flyer lineup and goal, we wouldn't have time to follow this play that goes back now, and it's Duncan Keith. Then along to Seabrook, bounced up the boards, and Gagné in front. Oh, and what a deflection in front right near Keith that had to be handled, and right back comes Chris Versteeg. He's got a man breaking ball in, and he can't make the play. Solid defensive back-checking job was done just now by Gagné. Gagné steps along trying to make a play. Emerging with it is Bufflin, trying to force his way by. Coming out is Layton, and he's able to one-hand it away. And it is tipped on out as far as center, where Taves played it back to Jalmerson. Quickly across off the boards to Campbell, then back ahead to Bufflin. Flyers had more surges in the first 7 or 8 minutes. Lately, it's been more of Chicago. This is played now by Campbell, handed across to Jalmerson. Bufflin and Kane and Taves are out there. Danny Briere, Billy Leno are out there, as well as Hartnell up front for the Flyers. Pronger connects to Carl. Back up the boards, played by Hartnell. Hartnell laid it across. Punted back in by Briere. Retrieved by Jalmerson. Up the boards, played further and taken away. Leno, a shot to save! Made by Niemi. Oh, a strong save there on a quick change of possession. Jab back out again by Brouwer. Taken along by Briere. Knocked right down by Hossa. And the puck has to be lifted off the linesman's skate. And it comes on back as far as Brent Sopel. Nice. Another change for the Flyers.
Nice little play there by Billy Leno, Doc. And then the second thing to follow up is a big rebound given up by Antti Niemi in that high slot, high traffic area.
Sharp tried to play that one on through, got in the way of the pass from the Flyers, tried to lead the point, but that's cut and started back out again by Carcillo. Carcillo tried to flip one in front, got it back again, and the shot was steered up out of play. 8:14 to go. First period, no score from Philadelphia.
Welcome back to Philly Scoreless in the first. Coach, you've got a lot of puck possession, not a lot of scoring chances. Are you happy with the pace?
Well, the pace is good both ways. Chicago came to play, too. It's a great hockey game. It's moving up and down. You're right, scoring chances, there's not that many at either end.
How do you keep this team in this moment right now?
Well, I think we're good. I mean, it's do or die for us right now. We got to stay here for 60 minutes.
Thanks, Peter.
Guys. Carissa and Peter, thank you very much. Yeah. Pays tribute to both his team and the other team. It has been really entertaining as we have a faceoff involving Briere and Boland. And Briere, Philadelphia Flyer top scorer, got it back for a shot that was blocked off by Versteegan. Another try went off of Boland. The shot blocking for Chicago so strong in the third period of game two is here again. Laid to the back again. Bartulis a shot, and that went off of Hartnell. Swept along into some traffic, but corralled and walked back ahead by Thomas Kopetsky. And the short hopper was grabbed by Mike Schmidt. And then now we have a stick that is apparently broken from Bartulis. And so the Flyers are powerless right now. Bartulis has just gotten another from Harry Bricker, the assistant equipment man. Puck skipped on through Seabrook. Rushing on his Gagne. Impeded a bit by Seabrook. And it's taken away by Duncan Keith. Keith throws that one ahead. Patrick Kane comes up the wing. Kane on a cross. Dealt it there. Bufflin a shot. Save rebound. Off the puck with the shot. The crowd buzzing is back. Up come the Flyers this time. It's Carter a shot. Blocked away by Niemi. Chicago's turn. Led on out. Grabbed off by Philadelphia's Carl and handed back to Pronger. And things settle into a line change with under 7 to go.
A beautiful execution there by Chicago on that odd man situation entering the offensive zone. But Brent Seabrook probably, Doc, should have got a penalty for interfering with Simon Gagne, who was looking to try to get to that loose puck. Seabrook lost his stick.
This is Pronger bringing it on. Given back up the wing and held there. Delaying is Asham, who has been tremendous in this playoff run for the Flyers. Dealt back along by Giroux. Grabbed off, though, and started right back out with a pass that came across for Campbell, who got out of the way of the hit he knew was coming from Asham. Twisting behind now, Braden Coburn. Knifed on further. Trying to get it was LaPerriere. It's fed on back for a little backhander by Campbell that's wide. Coburn tries the other side this time. It cannot be controlled. And we get a stoppage of play. A slashing call is being whistled. It'll be on a Blackhawk.
Well, there you saw the play by Brent Seabrook interfering with Simon Gagne. And from our Jack Daniels goal cam, a good look for Patrick Kane and Doc. That's about the fourth or fifth time Kane has found himself over on the left wing boards after the shot by Dustin Bufflin. A little give and go in the high slot area. And then Kane with a great chance. Second post of the period for Chicago.
Our EAS power play stats show you the overall marks in the playoffs. It is 2-for-7 for the Flyers, 0-for-3 power play for Chicago. And Pronger could not hold that one in. So back to neutral ice. The Flyers have gotten a power play goal in each of the first two games.
Well, there's the penalty, Marian Hossa. breaking the stick.
Heiminen cranked it in. Jalmerson fed it on. Madden drilled it further, but it's kept alive. Dealt back on by Pronger. Lifted on back now for Kimmo Tiimonen. Walks on in. Tiimonen gave it back. Pronger, a hurried shot. Looked like his stick may have broken, but it's still okay. Hands on across. It is an art drive that is blocked down by Jalmerson. Played by Richards along to Gagne. Back to Richards again. The challenge for Madden. Fed around in front to Gagne. Hacked at there by Carter. And Carter has it yet again as we're down to the last minute 20 of an eventful power play. But it is drilled back down the ice by Bolin. And Kareen behind for Leighton to set it up. Both teams make a change.
Nice pressure there by John Madden. Tough play for Jeff Carter, skating along that strong side and trying to pass the puck back. Good angle by Madden.
Fed on a cross. Save Niemi. Oh, what a save on Briere. Fed on a cross again. Oh, and another save Niemi. Save the net. Score!
The Flyers with a power play goal, but what a beautiful little pass there by Claude Giroux. Great stop by Antti Niemi. Chicago does not clear the puck. Watch the pass by Scott Hartnell. Right there, falling down, back the other way to Danny Briere in a wide open net. Three Blackhawks go to Hartnell, and then Danny Briere puts it in behind Antti Niemi. Doc, he was not able to absorb that shot. That allowed the rebound. Hartnell with the great pass. And Briere puts it into the wide open net.
11th playoff goal, fourth power play goal for Danny Briere. Here is Taves, bodied off by Betts. Sort of a careless pass across, but the Blackhawks escape with it, and it's laid back in by Hendry, slowed by Leighton. Betts came in and was boomed into by Bufflin. Trickled along now to Darryl Powell. Princeton product, lost it. Kane was stepped into. Battle continues, and Kane gave it across. Carl skipped it back out of harm's way. Another change for Philadelphia. So here is Bufflin laying one along that Patrick Sharp could not get. Flyers with speed back again. It's set back up to Giroux along with Carcillo, and Carcillo stumbled back behind the net as he was trying to make a play. Lifted on back. And icing is called. 4 minutes to go, first period. Hartnell and Coburn, the assists on Danny Briere's goal.
Well, Blair Betts with a little bit of cut above the right eye, but Danny Briere's had a terrific playoff. The shot by Braden Coburn, the effort by Hartnell, knowing that where the pressure was coming from, he could not take the shot towards the net, and just throwing it back almost through the traffic in Briere. Doc, the most important thing, I got a lot of young hockey players out there to watch, his stick was on the ice. If his stick's up here, maybe it goes by him. It was a heck of a play all the way around there by Hartman.
Strong man on the fundamentals is Danny Briere. Lifted back along by Seabrook, kept alive by Coburn. It skipped around to Mike Richards, gave one across, and a bad angle shot went wide. Played on back by Tiimonen. Jeff Carter got that one, turned it along to Gagne. Laid it on back, and Tiimonen is able to keep play alive. Finnish Olympian gave it off a stick, though, that of Carter. Lost by Sopel, but fortunately to Versteeg, and then on across where Bolin has to corral it more.
Hey, Doc, Kimmo Tiimonen got the puck at the point there, and this just what is, he's one of about four or five times the Flyers have had a chance to get the puck to the net, and they tried to make a play instead of shooting the puck to the net. And that was a good try there by Billy Leino. That's what I'm talking about. If you got a lane, you got to get it there. There's not always a better play by making a pass.
If Eddie Olczyk, the former coach of the Penguins, writes a book, it will be get the puck to the net or without goaltending, you have no shot. Those will be the working titles. Here's a shot by Carl that ricocheted off. Played back along by Campbell. Up the boards to Hossa. Skipped across to Sharp. Laid right back on for the carry by Duncan Keith. Keith dropped it back. Tipped by Brower. Played by Sharp. And the bouncer goes behind. They'll be able to play it back up the boards. It's offensive work now by Danny Briere again. Briere just dancing free. in a stick duel with Campbell. Stronger played it further, and it's Hartnell with him. Another duel with Campbell. This time the Blackhawks can start ahead. Marian Hossa shaking free, got into the zone. The ex-Red Wing and Penguin dropped it on back, and it's laid back further for the play to be made back out again. Be handled by Hendrick. Tiemannin, who made that play, comes to the bench for a change now. It's constant change from both benches. It seems like no one stays very long. Daniel Carcillo is going to get a minor penalty for that hit.
Yeah, bad penalty by Carcillo.
He will go to the box. Peter Laviolette is ticked off. It'll be a power play to the Blackhawks when we come back to angry Philadelphia.
I'm Bill Patrick. Ahead on the Pizza Hut Stanley Cup Final Intermission Report, I'm joined once again by Keith Jones, Brian Engblom. We'll break down the first period action here in Philadelphia. Plus, Hall of Famer Mark Messier will join us to announce the three finalists for the Mark Messier NHL Leadership Award presented by Bridgestone. It's all ahead, Doc.
Offensive zone face-off to begin this power play. Carcillo, a charging penalty at 18:05. The EAS power play stats show you the Blackhawks have not connected on a power play yet in this series. But their percentage overall has been very good. This is Taves, hands on back now for Keith. Sent it across, and a shot was deflected wide as Patrick Sharp had that try. Scaled away from Kane, and back as far as center where Taves was hawked by Richards.
Nice play there by Timo Tiemannin, firing that puck around the glass to make sure it got out near the blue line.
Handed across now to Kane, laid on back to Sharp. Given across now to Keith. Keith handed it over, and it's Kane with it, dealing in deep, and Taves tried to jam one away at the front of the net. They battle for it there, and still it's loose, and then reaching out, but not covering as the puck came free. But the whistle had been blown. It was Michael Layton trying to make the play as the netminder.
A good movement by the Blackhawks on this power play. Jonathan Taves, one little extra move. And the Mats scramble and a quick whistle with net presence going on by Dustin Byfuglien, Patrick Kane, and Jonathan Taves. Going to go back to the penalty. Here comes Dan Carcillo. Watch this slash. I thought that was the penalty, but the referee called charging. I didn't see a charge there, but what Peter Laviolette, he saw the replay up on the Jumbotron. I saw the initial slash with the stick, Doc. I thought that was the penalty. That's why I thought it was a bad penalty. But the referee said it was a charge. And that's why Chicago's on the power play.
Miami scoops it behind in the final minute of play in this first period. The shots are 9-8 in favor of the Blackhawks. The Flyers leading on their power play goal from Briere. Here's Hossa with a shot that's sent high and just over the outstretched reach of Layton. And it's whipped back down the ice, and Niemi will get it set again, this time to Seabrook. Changes in the penalty killers for the Flyers. Drilled back in again by Seabrook and rattled on around where it's played behind by Tiemannin. Braden Coburn tries to work further. Persistent work by Coburn, but it's held by Seabrook right at the line. Versteeg is hawked there, coming by a Seabrook. Nice reach there to get it back onto Versteeg. Chris Versteeg dealt it on back, but it's where he thought there was somebody, and Campbell just couldn't reach. So they have to pour back out again, and now they move back in. It's Campbell trying to get there, but play is called back because of an offside.
Not a good decision there by Chris Versteeg. A better choice there instead of trying to make a backhand pass with a vacated blue line position.
Baseball's newest phenom, 21-year-old right-hander Steven Strasburg, will start his last minor league game. The action tomorrow, 1 p.m. live on Versus, a replay at 7. The Syracuse Chiefs take on the Buffalo Bisons. He will start his first major league game for the Washington Nationals, June 8th, against the Pittsburgh Pirates, a 2009 number one draft pick in last year's draft.
How do you feel about that, Doc? Start to get your Bucks.
It'll be interesting. If he's not wearing a Cub hat, maybe they don't have their chances too soft. There is a rain delay in that one tonight, I understand, and that could benefit both teams. Here is a pass by Sharp. Ricocheted back in, and we'll get the horn. 5 seconds of power play time on the Carcillo minor, but a crowd is gathered here, and that's not unusual. In case you're curious, in all of these games played, there's only one fighting major on the two teams total, and that's Hartman.
It looks like there's only going to be one penalty right now. Referee Dan O'Halloran was pointing. It looks like he's pointing at Dustin Byfuglien right now. Have to let this thing all sort out. With a couple seconds left to go. There's a little bit of a shot by Byfuglien to the backside of Kimmo Tiiminen. Coming together. And there's definitely somebody's gonna have a power play here, Doc. It looked like to me, anyways, to start the second period. It looks like it's gonna be Philly on a power play.
Okay, stay tuned for the Pizza Hut Stanley Cup Final Intermission Report. Bill, Keith, and Brian after the break.
Final Intermission Report on Versus, delivered to you by Pizza Hut. Get any pizza, any size, any crust, and any toppings for one low price.
Well, Eddie Olczyk was absolutely right as Dustin Byfuglien of the Blackhawks was whistled for roughing at the tail end of the period. A two-minute penalty, so the Flyers on the power play to start the second period. And welcome back, everybody. Danny Briere, a power play goal. It's 1-0 Philadelphia. Our GEICO insider, Carissa Thompson, is with Danny Briere.
Thank you, Bill. Well, Danny, obviously we saw the emotion heat up. It's playoff hockey. It's the finals. How do you keep them in check? You don't want them to be on the man advantage.
Yeah, well, it's a fine line, and that's exactly what we talked about before the game, not crossing that line. I thought we did a really good job being physical all over the ice, but staying, for the most part, in control.
You guys seem to be picking right where you left off in the third of last game. What are you guys doing well out there right now?
I think our forecheck has been a lot better than at certain times in the first two games. We got to keep that pressure on their defensemen, and as long as you're spending time in their zone, it's a lot easier for our goaltender and our defenseman.
Got to give it up for your boy Hartnell keeping that play alive, huh?
Well, yeah, that was a great play. You know, we always thought that, you know, just put it back door. When you don't know what to do, that's exactly what he did on that play.
11th playoff goal came on the power play. Thanks, Danny. Bill?
All right, Carissa, thank you, and welcome, everybody, to the Pizza Hut Stanley Cup Final Intermission Report. Bill Patrick, Keith Jones, and Brian Engblom here. And Jonesy, the man sitting to your left, was absolutely right. He said, watch out for the power play and watch out for Briere's line.
Yeah, Danny Briere, again, terrific on the offensive side of things. Also defensively, but the line's got great chemistry. Scott Hartnell, the physical force on that line has been very good throughout this finals. 3 points in game one, and a big hit here to start things again against an important player for the Blackhawks in Brent Seabrook. Getting the pucks in the corner, keeping pucks alive. That's Hartnell's job. Billy Leno's got a high level of skill, and so does Danny Briere. But look at the skilled play by Scott Hartnell, sliding that puck over, allowing Danny Briere to pick up that goal. That line has been terrific. All three elements are there, and Hartnell's leading the way physically.
Marian Hossa said in his pregame interview that they'd have to be really good in the first 10 minutes, especially with their puck possession and puck distribution. Chicago was very good early on. Philadelphia came with a push, and Chicago knew it. Real nice breakout off the middle there. They were very calm. They made sure that they made puck passes to the right guy. They took their time coming out of their zone a lot. They didn't try to rush anything. Good breakout. Sometimes it was right across the ice. Other times they came out up the middle, and when the boards were open, they chose the right thing all the time. They did a really good job in front of their own net, blocking some shots, and they also put a lot of pressure on Daniel Carcillo. Carcillo made a couple of mistakes coming out of his own zone there, and then at the end of the period, big Dustin Byfuglien did take a penalty, but the Chicago Blackhawks were starting to get more physical. Remember, Chicago likes to play physical just as much as the Philadelphia Flyers. We anticipated this to escalate as the series went along, that power plays would become more important, and it's going down that road for sure.
All right, 1-0 Flyers after 20 minutes of play. Stay right where you are. When we come back, Hall of Famer Marc Messier joins us. Danny Briere, 11 goals, the most by a Flyer in one playoff year since Eric Lindros had 12 in 1997. We got back. And welcome back inside the Wachovia Center. 1-0 Flyers. The man to my left needs no introduction, but I'm going to do it anyway. Hall of Famer Marc Messier is here joining us. And, Mess, first of all, give me your impressions of the series so far. A pair of one-goal games. We've got another one tonight.
Well, great game so far. I thought Philadelphia had an opportunity to win in the first game. They probably felt they let it slip away. But overall, they've had their chances in both games there, and the season or the series easily could be tied 1-1 right now.
Okay, you join us every year to talk about the Mark Messier Leadership Award finalists, and you're here to announce the finalists. Let's first of all take a look at the three men who are the finalists: Sidney Crosby of Pittsburgh, Shane Doan of Phoenix, and Ryan Miller of Buffalo. Let's first of all talk about what the Leadership Award is all about.
Well, the Leadership Award is designed to recognize the players that are not only doing tremendous things on the ice, but also what they're doing off the ice as well in their communities, being good citizens, reaching out to the children, showing compassion to the children, helping out hospitals, doing all the things that would make us proud of our players. And we want to recognize, and we got a lot of players doing great things, and so in order to really kind of put the spotlight on them and the NHL and be proud of our players, and the NHL felt the award is worthy of making it happen, and we've done that, and so far we're in our fourth year.
All right, let's talk about the finalists this year, leading off with Sidney Crosby.
Well, what more can I say about Sidney Crosby? He's done everything that is expected of him coming into the league as a guy that's the face of the NHL. Back-to-back Stanley Cup Finals, winning a Stanley Cup game-winning goal in the Olympics this year has been unbelievable. Youngest captain ever, I think, to captain the team to the Stanley Cup. And he gives himself tirelessly to the kids in the Pittsburgh area, and not to mention Nicole Harbour. So just an unbelievable kid, unbelievable player, and we're proud of him.
The unquestioned leader of the Phoenix Coyotes is Shane Doan.
Well, surprised right there, I think, from the outset. Nobody could have expected the Coyotes to have the year that they did there. And you have to say one thing about it is that probably because of the leadership that they had. Shane Doan, I've got to know him as a person, tremendous person off the ice. He's led this team for a group of guys that didn't have much leadership at the start of the year because of the ownership situation. Led them not only to a great season, one of the best seasons ever, but also into the playoffs. And again, another guy that reaches out to a tremendous amount of charities around the Phoenix area there, and great citizen.
And a man who could win the Vezina Trophy, Ryan Miller of Buffalo.
Well, he might be the best goalie in the world right now, or arguably the best goalie in the world right now. He's done everything that's expected to of him, and when the spotlight was on him in the Olympics this year, he played amazingly, kept the Americans in it, came down to the showdown there with Crosby and him, but what a goaltender. And again, another guy that just gives himself tirelessly to the charities and off the ice, and a guy that's shown a tremendous amount of passion to the kids that have fallen ill with cancer. And I think a nephew fell stricken with cancer. So, you know, all three finalists are deserving, and that's probably the toughest job as I have, trying to find three finalists, and then of course one winner, because there's so many guys in the NHL that are doing great things on and off the ice.
All right, unfortunately we're out of time, but thank you once again for stopping by.
Thanks for having me.
The winner will be announced Wednesday, June 23rd, during the 2010 NHL Awards from Las Vegas, which can be seen live right here on Versus. Now let's check in with Liam McHugh of the Daily Line. We are back with the Enterprise Players of the Week, led by Danny Briere, who set a Flyers record with 4 points in Game 1. He scored the only goal of this game so far. Marian Hossa, 3 points in 2 games, and Antti Niemi has been a rock in goal for Chicago.
This has been the Pizza Hut Stanley Cup Final Intermission Report on Versus, delivered to you by Pizza Hut. Get any pizza, any size, any crust, and any toppings for one low price.
Welcome back to the NHL Stanley Cup Final on Versus, presented by Geico, to Bob Harwood with an honored guest.
Doc, thank you very much. It was supposed to be turmoil in Phoenix. It became 50 wins and a playoff berth, and Don Maloney is GM of the year. Congratulations, Don. For those of us on the outside, you had to cut through a lot of stuff to build a hockey team. How tough was that?
Well, it was a challenge, but really it's an organizational award. The coaches, the players, the trainers, the scouting staff really did a heck of a job.
You brought free agents in over the summer. You got them to see through the haze. What did you promise them?
Well, you know, I think it's a credit to Phoenix and the great city and the great building, and no promises, a chance to win.
Don, congratulations on the winning culture. We appreciate it.
My pleasure.
All right, Doc, back to you.
Power play is on for the Flyers here. It was a penalty to Buffalo. That was the only one in the skirmish at the end of the first period. The Flyers who scored earlier on the power play go to work here. Billy Leno on the return pass went off. Sofel battled for it, and it's sent across where Pronger can quiet it all down by handing it on now to Gagne. Then back to Pronger again. Pronger led it across, held there by Tiemannin. Back to Pronger, and a shot is kicked aside by Brent Sofel. Blackhawks have done a great job blocking shots here. This one came loose and was flexed back toward the corner by Leno and tipped across, and here's Richards dealing it on back yet again to Pronger. Richards sent it back. Tiemannin had trouble but settled it down and blasted one that was knocked down the front side of the net. Oh, and what a save by Niemi that time on Gagne. Another try in front. It's Leno up with it there. Hands it on back for the play to Pronger. And that one kicked right back, and John Madden with a broken stick cannot be any further into the play. He comes to the bench for a change. Back in come the Flyers again. Centering pass. Oh, and that one wouldn't go either. It looked like a great setup. But now it comes back there for a feed. Oh, and a remarkable play in front of the net. It was Richards letting it go. I don't know if it was stopped by Niemi or at least blocked or whether it just screamed by. It was such a strong shot.
What a play by Billy Leno, Doc. He made a couple of terrific plays on this power play chance for the Flyers. Looks like Richards might have airmailed that chance.
This is Coburn given to Giroux. That one deflected, couldn't be cleared by Sofel, but is sent back out to center ice anyway.
Boy, Giroux's got to shoot that puck again, trying to be a little bit too fine.
15 blocks by the Chicago Blackhawk defenders. Along to get this now as Giroux scaled it behind. It went stiffly off a foot, but is corralled and sent back by Briere. But he cannot get it through, and then it is thrown on back to center. Dustin Byfuglien is free from the box and in the forechecking role here. 2:15 played, second period, 1-0 in favor of Philadelphia.
Two tired defensemen out there for the Blackhawks. Nicholas Jalmerson and Brent Sofel right now. Fortunate bounce there for Chicago.
Kane gave it to Versteeg. Versteeg wheels to the outside, throws it along, comes to the bench for a change himself. Taken along and worked further now. Taken by Patrick Sharp and laid around behind, trying to fight free was Hossa. Not free, but taken on now by Patrick Kane. Here's Kane taking a look across. One-time shot! They score! A drive by Keith, and the game is tied!
Well, after the penalty kill for the Blackhawks, a little line juggling going on by Joel Quenneville, but this shot is deflected. But before that, the opportunity for the Flyers. In the left part of your screen, Patrick Kane has lots of time. It's going to go to the point, but the stick in front, it goes off the stick of Jeff Carter. Right there, it goes up and over the glove of Michael Layton. No chance. But the heads-up play there by Kane to get the puck to Keith. No hesitation at all. One time the puck. Fortunate bounce for Chicago. Bad break for Philly. Tied up at one.
Locked down and started right back again by Byfuglien, and a blast had to be steered aside by Leighton. Played on by Hossa, but lost. Given back to LaPerriere. Drop back further to Pronger. Angles it on ahead, and it is marched right back in again by Blair Betts. Betts able to get behind, try to wrap around, and it went off the goal stick of Niemi. Paws a man right out of the way, getting up slowly now as Powell. Meanwhile, the attack on, and here comes Hossa. Hossa spinning with it, feeds it on back. A shot by Campbell knocked down. Another try, and that one blocked away by Leighton. What a try by Hossa, and a penalty coming up against Philadelphia. The call is a high stick and a power play to the Blackhawks.
I think it's going to be on Chris Pronger.
Philadelphia number 20, a minor high sticking.
Oh, what an opportunity. Great play there by Marian Hossa. The shot from the point, blocked in front. And net presence by Dustin Byfuglien. But Hossa made the play. Remember the play that Powell made in that first period? Spinning off a check, protecting a puck. That's exactly what Hossa did to create that chance.
Kept alive by Seabrook, fed back across for the play back in by Versteeg. Bad angle shot went off of Leighton and is cleared back down the ice. Still looking for power play goal number one in the series, the Blackhawks. Hossa walks this one ahead. takes his own pass. Menace there by Giroux, tried to get to the front, no, said Timonen, but around it swirled, on for Brian Campbell. Given back to him again. Campbell looks to jam it back in deep, played by Hossa further. Given back by Versteeg to Campbell. Campbell with a drive, knocked down in front, on a swat of the glove by Layton. Good defensive play there, and a great offensive tip and try at the front of the net.
Great glove by Michael Layton. Brian Campbell has a chance to move this puck all the way to camera right, but there's the redirect. And I don't know if the initial tip from Marion Hossa got to Michael Layton. I think it might have went off Troy Brower, Doc. Slowed up and up, and then Michael Layton from our Jack Daniels goal cam. You're able to see Layton grabbing that puck.
It is Keith on a cross, and Kane, a shot steered wide by Timonen and jammed back out in front, but can be controlled back out again by the Flyers. Nearly halfway through their penalty kill, Darryl Powell moves in, jostled there by Buffalin, and so Keith can play.
That shot by Patrick Kane, Doc, he didn't get a lot on it because he broke his stick. He went to the bench to get a new one.
Kane able to play it back along with his new stick now. Holds to the outside. There's another stick that is out there broken in half. Probably his. Drive by Sharp, and a sizzler went wide. On back now to Keith. Duncan Keith dropped it right back in again. Kane able to get it there. One and a back pass for Buffalo. No luck. Matt Carl, feverish work, but it's grabbed off by Keith and kept alive by Chicago. Just now jammed out to center where Taves gives it across. Two shots so far by Chicago on this power play, and the Blackhawks wheel back in the last 20 seconds of it. Kane dropped it off. Sharp took it there. Moved on in deeper, and a shot ricocheted wide off of Kopetsky. Jammed on back to Sharp again. To the last 10 of the power play. Led it across, and he's set up for the big blast. Didn't do it just yet. Taves a shot, and that one tipped up high, and it winds up going out of play.
We talked about the battle between Chris Pronger and Dustin Byfuglien throughout the Stanley Cup final. But during this second half of the power play, Thomas Kopetsky and Matt Carl in front of the net. The shot by Jonathan Taves. And a good stop there by Michael Layton. And when you're playing in front of the net like that, Doc, and the puck is moving from side to side, blue line across, as a guy in front, you have to mirror where that pass is going. So you have to anticipate, start moving when that puck moves. If you wait while that puck goes from one side to the other, players are too big and too good. They're going to box you out. And all it takes is that split second to be a step slow to allow your goaltender, allow the goaltender to see that puck.
So you're talking about the offensive player that's watching his teammate have it back deep there.
That's it. You got to anticipate when that puck is moving and know that's going to go side to side. You have to mirror the puck.
A jostling hit there by Ben Eager, emerging with it to play behind his heart. 6 minutes played, second period, tie game. Billy Leno has been dangerous. Left a pass that is taken away from Burrish and nudged in front, but quickly spiked wide. Hartnell after it again. A bouncer couldn't be settled down by Leno. Would have been an artful play had he done it, and offside is called.
Nice play by Breer in behind the net to lift the stick of Burrish to keep that play alive.
14 shots to 11, Chicago. Breer and Keith are the goal scorers tonight.
Welcome back to Philly. We are all tied up, and Danny Briere on the board for Philly, and he's doing good both on and off the ice. When you purchase a Briere Bunch autograph hat, you are donating to Camp Good Days, a camp that helps kids with cancer, a very important cause and close to Danny's heart. Proceeds also benefit the Flyers Wives Carnival and Danny Briere Foundation. Danny also wanted me to give a shout out to Shane Doan, who, as we heard during the intermission, has also excelled on and off the ice and in the community. So very good thing all the way around, guys.
Boy, there are so many strong players, not just athletes, but players in their community. Here comes Hartnell around in front, and that one skipped off the netminder Niemi. And is carried back out now for the lob back in by Versteeg. So now very obedient changes. They've been very rapid, but now they seem to have settled down a little bit. A few longer shifts I'm noticing here in the second than I saw in the first.
We also saw J.P. Dumont in one of those pictures, Doc. Nashville Predator and a former teammate of Danny Briere. The Buffalo Sabres.
Couple of players down. Taves without a stick. Swung away by Kane, and a hard drive was blocked there by Niemi. Briere with a rising shot, and it went off the glass. He remembered what they said. Go high with the shot. Taves without a stick. Still gets it advanced ahead now, and it's Kane swinging back to Bufflin. Bufflin's shot went off the leg of Pronger. Flyers hustle it back. Briere trying to fight it back in. It's rattled on around all the way near Leno. Oh, was he ever run over by Brent Seabrook. And it is Keith. Got a little help there from Taves because he was being impeded strongly by Briere. Keith able to just drop back away from the forecheck of Carter to give to Seabrook, then back across for a little bounce pass ahead that came from Versteeg.
Good smart little play there by Versteeg. He felt pressure there, Doc. Instead of trying to force something, just went right up the boards.
Nice steal by Versteeg. He moves in. He's got Kopetsky. Can't get the shot away. What a play made defensively by Matt Carl. Lobbed on back, and it was an offside as it had come out and was brought in.
You talk about missed opportunities, Doc. Right before the goal by the Blackhawks, that great chance by Mike Richards, and then Kane to Keith, the deflection off of Carter in behind the net, and then a great steal by Christopher Stieg. He's got this puck, tries to make the backhand pass over, and an outstanding defensive play there by Matt Carl.
Carl and Pronger have been a pair on this team. Pronger, a first-year Flyer. 14 straight playoff appearances for him. Chris Pronger, the leader in shifts and in ice time in 2 1/3 games of this series. That's how many have been played. Ahead now comes Sharp, chased off by Tiemannin. Moving on is Hossa, outreached the big defenseman there, Braden Coburn, but it's played back along by Campbell. Taken further. Oh, Sharp, a shot. A pass in front and a shot by Brower that was high and wide. Thrown back off now by Asham, but again started back by the Blackhawks, who are in the midst of some concerted offensive effort here.
And another big hit by Braden Coburn on Brian Campbell coming up those left wing boards.
Back in for Sokol to have another try. Did not err on that one. Hossa led it across. Campbell marched it on. Ryan Campbell able to turn to the outside. Down one in front that had to be geared away by Michael Layton. Sharp is run into. Meanwhile, Gagne sets it for Giroux. Knocked across by Ben Eager and carried right back in again by Burrish. And a backhander was calmly steered away by Layton, and the net is dislodged. They say that a Blackhawk is responsible, so the faceoff will be outside. The NHL Stanley Cup Final continues Sunday on NBC if necessary. After two games at home, the Flyers head back to Chicago to face the Blackhawks and their hometown fans. Although those hometown fans are hoping it doesn't get there. The NHL Stanley Cup Final Game 5, part of NBC Sports Championship season, Sunday, 8 Eastern on NBC.
Doc, go back to the first period where we went, where we go, about almost 5+ minutes without a whistle. It's important for both coaches. Your rotations are going on, getting all of your players involved. Sometimes you don't have a choice because you go long stretches. You're not able to get those matchups. So all 12 forwards, all 6 defensemen are going to get their opportunity. More others in certain situations. But you got to use your bench because you just don't know when you're going to be able to get off the tracks or get a whistle. Be able to get the matchups you may want, or even just a breather for some guys. You could just keep going on and on and on.
Well, what about shift length now? At the start of the game, we were seeing so many short ones because they were trying to do these matchups. What's a normal shift length for the midway in the second period, and how does that compare to later in the game?
Well, I think because of the long changes, first of all, Doc, on that point in the second period, your bench is the farthest away from your defensive zone, so you want to make sure that you're changing a little bit earlier. So it probably cuts down your shift length, depending if you can get off the ice, probably by a good 5 to 7 seconds. And the average shift length, if you take a look at the, some of the numbers for guys that played in that first period, anywhere between 34 and 41 at even strength. It's a little different on the power play because some guys extend their shift probably a little bit longer than most coaches would want on a power play situation. Again, sometimes the surge and the pace of the game dictates how long your shifts are.
Here's Kane leading it back. Seabrook giving it across, and Keith gives to Seabrook, and a drive, and that one rattled around in front. Taves couldn't make a play. Good work done in front there by Carter, and we're going to get a stoppage of play. We have a slash that is signaled, and Dustin Bufflin appears to be the man who will head to the box.
Well, Chris Pronger's leaving the ice without a stick. And Bufflin was standing in front of the net with Pronger.
33 Chicago, Miner, Blaskin.
So Bufflin getting to the front of the net. There's a little bit of a cross check by Pronger. And there's this slash. Not a good penalty there by Dustin Bufflin. You're almost better off, Doc, instead of coming over the top. You're better off to try to lift up instead. You got a better chance of not breaking the stick. And we know we talk about the problem in the league with sticks breaking so easy.
To the outside on this power play, Giroux handing back to Thiemann and drive! Toe save, Niemi, big scramble in front! And the whistle is blown remarkably. He was able to cover that. Well, at one time when you were playing and it wasn't ancient times, everybody used wood. So you'd slash a guy like that and the stick wouldn't break, nor would yours.
And wood is good. Not a lot of guys using the wood stick, but off a face-off win. Philadelphia Flyers right now dominating in the face-off circle. 16-7 for the Flyers to this point, Doc. And that play all started because of a face-off win. And there's another one by Giroux.
Thiemann gave it across, and it's returned to him. Dropped one in deep, taken to the outside by Giroux, handed back to Pronger. His shot, triple off the post! They have sounded the goal horn, but there's no reason to. It did not go in. Now the light is turned on behind. Meanwhile, a shot hopped around to the outside, and we get a continuation of the play. What have you seen?
Doc, from my vantage point, that puck looked like it went across the line from where I am sitting.
It is spun across by Pronger. On the power play, dealt back in, and a shot, a riser that went hopping off of the netminder Niemi by Briere. Now it's fed along to Giroux. Giroux led it back. Thiemann gave it across, got it back, let it go! And that flexed away as Niemi got in the way of that shot. Here's Hossa touching it ahead, and the skipper was just away from Taves, trying to duel his way in front with 45 to go. We're assuming they're going to take a look at this, but not until play stops. Here's a centering pass in front that's tipped on back, held by Matt Carl. Carl led it back. A pass ricocheted in front, battling for it, Leno, and he pushed a shot off of Seabrook, and it's sent right back down by the Blackhawks. Buzz going through the crowd. Some of them think they saw what Eddie Olczyk saw, the puck over the line. Thrown in front, and that went wide.
The puck was on edge, Doc. And a quick stick came in. So what will happen is once they get a stoppage, there will be a video review, regardless of what happens. And there's a possible say, here comes an icing call. So play will be stopped. There will be a video review. The shot came from the point. Chris Pronger with the shot, and it was a knuckleball, Doc. Now the shot's gonna come in. I want everybody to watch the puck. It changes direction. Now the puck's sliding across, gets across, you stop it right here. Now look at, right there's the line. It's clearly on this side of the goal line. The stick comes in from Nicholas Jalmerson. The puck has to completely come across the line, even if it's on it. Doc, if that puck is on it flat, there's a part of that puck that's on the red line. Because it turned over on its side, the puck, in my vantage point, in my view, this puck completely crosses the goal line.
Boy, was that ever a good look at. There has to be white between the puck and the red line.
Back to the overhead. Again, this puck is on edge. It hits the post. Jalmerson's there, and there clearly. It's not even right there, right there. And now the clock will go back. If it is deemed a good goal, the clock will go back to when that puck crossed the goal line. So there will be more time put back on the clock. So it's almost, in essence, this play never started or never counted. And you'll go back to 5-on-5. But the Flyers, Doc, should have a 2-1 lead with a power play goal. And that was around the 9:50 mark. So really, almost 90 seconds of play will get put back on the clock. And did you imagine, though, Doc, in the scenario? And we're going to hear the call from referee Bill McCreary.
Upon further review, we have a good goal.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks, Doc. Chris Pronger with the shot. This puck was on edge. And Scott Hartnell's the guy that redirects this puck, and he will get credit for the goal. And how about the play by Nicholas Thomason, Doc, to be able to pull that puck without sticking the stick inside the net or the post, or even knocking it into his own net even farther. But that puck just took a spin on its side. And I believe, Doc, if that puck is flat, that puck does not completely get across the goal line. Power play goal should be given to Hartnell.
Red light flashed, and that is controlled by goal judges who used to sit behind the net but now are up top with us. Here is Tave swinging one to the corner. Played to the outside now by Versteeg. Versteeg drifting further, went down to the ice. That skipped off of Tave. Shoulder there by Kopetsky. Along to Taves, but Gagne in the way. Tipped on by Taves, taken by Kopetsky again. Shook it back around behind. Versteeg tried to turn, could not. Locked up by Krajicek. Rollicking his way in is Kopetsky. And it's nub free. Walk back ahead by Mike Richards, tried to play it back in, and we get an offside call. Play halted with 9:01 to go, second period. It was 1-1, thanks to review and Eagle Eye Eddie.
I guess that's Belgium.
It is 2-1 in favor of the Flyers. One more look. On its edge and over.
Chicago trails 2-1. Here's Joel Quenneville. Joel, it's been push, counter push. How well has your team handled that so far?
Well, we've been all right. I know that they got two power play goals, very timely for them, but I like the pace of our game here. You know, I think the transition game is going to be important.
It's a small step by an important player, but Patrick Kane gets on the score sheet. Can you see the confidence building?
Yeah, he's going tonight. He's got the puck a lot, making some nice plays. It's dangerous.
Joel, thank you.
You betcha.
Doc, back to you.
Bob, thank you. Kane and Hossa, the assists on Keith's goal. Joel Quenneville feels pretty good about the way his team is playing right now. Swung ahead by Leno. It's going to be as long in the category of Giroux as a forward who can make a difference and is not on the big three on this team. 22 in orange, Billy Leno, who at this time a year ago was playing for the Stanley Cup as a member of the Red Wings. Try was blocked down. Chalmerson run into with authority by Hartnell. To get an offside call.
And to go back to that goal. I want everybody to watch the stick here of Scotty Hartnell. The shot is going to come from the point, but watch the shot from Pronger. There's Scotty Hartnell in front of the net. Stick on puck, and this puck goes straight down to Antti Niemi. You can see where his vision is. He's looking ahead, and then the puck changes direction. Watch the left part of your screen, the stick of Hartnell right there. This puck is probably right around waist high. By the time it hits the Emmy dot, it hits him right low on the pad. So the redirect by Hartnell. Right now they've given it to Pronger, but that should be Hartnell's goal. Great hand-eye coordination. And a good, tippable shot.
Eavesdroppers we know down below are saying that Pronger has even said at the bench area that it was not his goal, it was Hartnell. So we expect it to be changed. This one is knifed down and played safely on back by Dustin Bufflin.
One thing that Joe Quenneville told Bob Harwood, Doc, that kind of sticks out is that the transition game, the defensemen being active for Chicago, that's when they're really playing their game. Their D get involved. Defense to offense with their defensive being right in the center of a lot of that transition in the middle of the ice.
Jordan Henry was able to keep this one, laid it along now for Tate. Kane trying to shake free in front, hoping a pass will come there. No luck because of Matt Carl. 7.5 to go. Second period. 2-0 Blackhawks in the series. 2-1 Flyers in game 3. Lobbed ahead just by the reach of Kane. Coming back is Pronger to knock it away. And then Pronger tumbles to the corner. Here's Bufflin crossing. And a shot. And a scramble there on the rebound. They're trying to poke away, but it's sealed by Layton.
This play all starts because of the turnover by Dan Carcillo. You got to keep the puck going ahead. You cannot start trying to stick handle through the middle of the ice. Kane almost has a breakaway. Pronger loses an edge, a little help from Kane. And then Bufflin takes the puck hard to the net, forces Michael Layton to make a play. Carcillo was going straight down the boards, and he brings the puck to the middle of the ice. You're not going to be able to make plays on your backhand. Straight ahead, get the puck to the net. Turnover, Doc. Long changes in the second period. Almost turns it all in to a real good opportunity for Chicago.
It is shoved wide by Adam Burge. The initial try was from Duncan Keith. LaPerriere off the stick of Keith. LaPerriere had it knifed away by Keith. Powell could not come up with that. Burge moves in and is shoved off. And so it's Duncan Keith yet again. Buried by the hit from LaPerriere, but from his knees, able to lay it around behind. Flyers are going to have to hurry to get everybody back, but right now they're in the midst of a line change. Blair Betts wound that one back around. Oh, and a trip that Chris Pronger got away with. Carried right back ahead now by Gagne. Dropped it back. Carter, a shot fought off by Niemi, and the rebound was hacked away by Campbell.
That trip by Pronger got accidentally on purpose there. Should have been a penalty.
Rifled across and back checked away by Gagne. Long pass is knifed out of the air with a high stick of Poland. Play continues because the Flyers were next to touch it. So Seabrook reverses and Jalmerson takes. Little over 6 minutes to go, second period. And it is trapped by Layton. And Carl having some words across the way too with Christie. Let's take a look at the Stoley storyline.
Well, Danny Briere, second goal of the series. I thought he was outstanding in game one. 4 points. Duncan Keith getting the puck to the net. And Scotty Hartnell's fifth of the playoffs. A little redirect after a video review.
You know, the intriguing thing, and I know we wanted to get that in at the time of the review or shortly after. The Blackhawks had a couple of chances to score after the red light flashed right in that 90 seconds.
Yeah, that was what I was getting to back before Phil McCreary was going to give us the judgment on the video review. If by chance Chicago would have scored in that time, that goal would have been disallowed and they would have put the goal on the board that should have been awarded to Philadelphia. Talking about a change in momentum.
And some places, had it gone against the home team, a timeout for debris. Here is Keith pulling away from Billy Leno. Duncan Keith strides ahead, able to shake Briere. It's across now to Sharp. Sharp stashed one in front, but it was nicely blocked away by Leno, but taken then and wormed along by Kopetsky. Kopetsky tried to shake one in front, and it ricocheted off very tight defense from Braden Coburn. Towards Campbell, got it to Sharp, fed it in front, Hosa can't get loose, and then a shot by Sharp was blocked out. Scramble there, and Sharp has to play it behind. Back pass, and we get a stoppage of play. The net is dislodged.
Might be a delay of game here, Doc, on the Flyers. Thomas Kopetsky should just get right out of there. Duncan Keith doing a good job to get Kopetsky out of there, knowing there's going to be a power play coming up for Chicago.
We will return to Wachovia Center with that, with 5:01 to go in the second and the home team up by one.
I'm Bill Patrick as the Flyers lead 2-1. A reminder coming up on the Verizon Stanley Cup Final Intermission Report. I'm joined once again by Keith Jones and Brian Engblom. We'll be breaking things down through two periods here in Philadelphia. Plus, you've got a closer look at the Flyers captain, Mike Richards. It's all ahead, guys.
There they are, waiting.
Nice vantage point
there. It is. They get a good look at it from the end.
Boy, Jonesy looks good with that blue shirt on, too.
Speak for yourself.
Oh, here's a penalty delay a game. Scotty Hartnell bumping into Michael Layton, and Layton lifting that net off his moorings. And there you see the referee. Great positioning there by Dan O'Halloran. Power play Chicago.
Clear is my bet. He and Powell are up front. Tiemannen and Pronger in back. Carried ahead by Keith. Taves is out there. Kane, the trailer, takes the pass. Moved it along, tried to shake through. Wedged off enough by Pronger that it slowed him down. Played back up the boards to Keith. Swept it on across, held there by Sharp, and sent right back around again, where Sharp gets the return pass and then hands on now to Taves. Taves chased away by the reach of Powell. Comes back for more and sets up Sharp. Sharp tried to play it through, and Blair Betts, an eagle eye, able to just clear it right back down. Sometimes a pass is weak because you anticipate what's going to happen because of the guy who is so skilled opposite you. Maybe that's what happened there, but it's Taves walking it ahead, giving it on to Patrick Kane. Kane with a nice spinorama. Puck kicked on back, but he set up for Keith. Handed on across now, and a shot.
shot by Taves was blocked away by Tiemannin. Drugged around behind by Buffland. Rattled on around all the way up to Keith. Duncan Keith played it on through Kane. Around to Buffland behind. Watched there by Tiemannin. Then Richards. It bounced off Richards and Buffland got some help to keep play alive across to Kane. Kane with a shot around in front. Oh, and it scooped off of Taves. And a rising shot glanced off of Braden Coburn. Kept alive by Sharp and one. Ricocheted on back and can be played by the Flyers. And they're able to clear it back away from Giroux and down.
Boy, Giroux almost had a breakaway. Everybody anticipated. The Blackhawks thought that the Flyers were going to shoot the puck down Mike Richards. But Doc, great patience. He held on to it and just airmailed it a little bit past Giroux, who tried to catch it.
Campbell connects back ahead. Here's Kopetsky having it knifed off his stick from behind by Powell, and then Kopetsky rammed into Carl. And cleared back down. Betts comes to the bench for a well-deserved rest. Did he ever do a good job on that penalty kill? One shot by the Blackhawks on it. Finessing is Holsa. Remarkably getting by, and then he couldn't get a good shot away, but Versteeg sure could, and it was wide. Now Campbell around behind. Can't get the back pass there. Holsa takes it. Roughed up a bit by Hartnell. Puck taken by Hartnell and popped on out to center just away from the reach of Briere.
What a great chance there for Chris Versteeg. He lifted up the stick of Pronger and just missed to the stick side of Leighton.
Played on to Kopetsky. Backhander went off of Leighton and it started back the other way by Leno. Gives back on to Briere. Briere trying to get by the defensive Chalmerson, but it's Sofel to read it there. Back up for Versteeg. Nice spinorama, and he has lost his helmet. No penalty coming up. Meanwhile, it's taken along to the outside by Troy Brower. To the last 2:10 of the period, play is stopped.
Boy, Scotty Hartnell gets away with the penalty in front of his bench. He was going for a change. Chris Versteeg coming up. Here comes Hartnell. Versteeg knows he's coming. And there, a punch to the back of the head. Helmet coming off. Versteeg lays there for a second, Doc. Maybe trying to sell this call. But no penalty called.
It has been the case in the last 2 years that the average number of power plays goes down in the final series. The average has been 8 or 9 in the first 3 rounds the last 2 years. Normally, it went up during the final, not down. Sofel scores! Off the faceoff, Brent Sofel has blasted one that has tied the game.
Well, a faceoff win for John Madden. The puck's going to end up going back to the point. Madden wins a faceoff. Now, stop here. The shot is coming in this direction. Michael Leighton, this puck gets on him quick. And right by him. Not sure if Lukáš Krajicek has screened him at all. But the shot by Sofel. Well, I think maybe a little bit of a screen there, Doc. Lukáš Krajicek kind of standing there in no man's land. But the faceoff win by the veteran Madden. And a big goal for Chicago very late in the second period. Twos are wild in game 3 here late in the second.
Carried on by Versteeg and lobbed back in. Jab behind by David Bolin. Coburn there chops it away from the onrushing Ben Eager. Half boards, it's stymied a bit by Burrish. Coming by for the reach is Eager. 2 years a part of this organization. Flyers give it up, and it is nicely kept there by Keith. But along to take it is Coburn, and Coburn just lobbed a bouncer back out again. Two power play goals by the Flyers. Two answers have come from Blackhawk defense team. First Duncan Keith and then Brent Sofel.
We talked about how much Philadelphia has done a good job, Doc, having the numbers as far as faceoffs. Chicago finally wins one and the puck ends up in the back of the net.
Knifed away from Ashen, laid out by Madden, flicked back in on the backhand of Eager. One more change, Eager out hawkishly here on the forecheck. And tried to take a man, he got part of one. Meanwhile, it's controlled and then angled back in by Asham. It ricocheted off Taves, set up by Kane, and flicked along, and Asham able to start ahead. Kane right on him, though. It is away and then off of Carcillo. Carcillo tried to center, but that was deflected away by the defense and started back out again by Buffland. Buffland moves it back ahead for Kane, but it was behind him, and it causes an offside.
And that was a clean faceoff win for John Madden. Anticipation off a faceoff. Domination,
in game one by Chicago, winning 68% in game one. Game two, pretty close, almost dead even, and then there's the face-off win. Clean win by John Madden over Mike Richards. And Brent Stoeppel, no hesitation, Doc. Just fire the puck towards the net. Puck possession, all it takes is one. One face-off.
One is an interesting number, too. There's only been one flyer shot on goal in the last 10 minutes. Here's a drive by Hartnell that's blocked away by Niemi.
Just heard you.
Another try, and that one blocked by the defense this time. So their number is at two over that stretch as we're down to the last quarter minute of the second period. And it is quiet here. In a 2-2 tie, time for one last attempt to the net. Danny Briere will not be able to do that because of Hjalmarsson, and that's it.
Well, lots going on, Doc. Talk about faceoffs. Danny Briere anticipates his puck. He wins the faceoff. Watch the stick of Jonathan Toews right there under the shield of Danny Briere. And we got to worry about winning faceoffs, but you got to worry about protecting everything. Part of your equipment.
Those boys are rugged. They're letting them play. Horizon Stanley Cup Final Intermission Report. Bill, Keith, and Ryan after the break.
This is the Verizon Stanley Cup Final Intermission Report on Versus. Verizon, the network with the most 3G coverage.
And welcome back inside the Wachovia Center in Philadelphia. What a series, what a game. Game three, 2-2 after 40 minutes of play. Brent Stoeppel ties the game late in the second period. Let's check in with our Geico insider, Bob Harwood, who is with Stoeppel.
Bill, thank you very much. Brent, you're a shot blocker first. At the other end, do you think about what those guys are looking for in terms of trying to stop your odd tee up?
Yeah, you know, Flyers do a great job, you know, getting in lanes, and they're blocking a ton of shots. So I just, kind of looked around and tried to get it by them, trying to hit the net, and, you know, found a way in.
Is this going to be a case of every shot is a smart one and a good one from here on in, 2-2 after 40?
Yeah, definitely. You can't turn the puck over. They got great transition, a lot of speed. You got to be smart with it. They block the shot. They try and turn it the other way.
How much have you said about keeping Michael Layton busy, making him have to be active?
Just like any other goalie. You got to get traffic in pucks in the net. If they can't see the puck, it's tough for them to defend.
Brent, thanks a lot.
Thanks very much.
Bill, back to you.
All right, Bob, thanks a million. Welcome, everybody, to the Verizon Stanley Cup Final Intermission Report. Bill Patrick, Keith Jones, and Brian Engblom here. You spoke earlier this evening about the Philadelphia power play, and you must be impressed with it.
Yes, I am. It looks a lot like the Philly power play in Game 1. I thought they were much better in Game 1 than they were in Game 2. They're really good in this Game 2. They set it up. They're mixing it up really well, moving the puck around the outside and ultimately getting the puck to the net. Danny Briere jamming that one in. Look at this. Looking for plays. Richard should have had another goal. He had the whole empty side of the net, and he missed the net. Billy Leno, magician in the middle of the ice, moving it around. That's the shot from the point that trickled over the line, and will play 61 minutes and 40 seconds in this game instead of 60 minutes because of it. But the power play had to be big for the Flyers. This is a very important game for them, but I like what they've done. They're getting shots from the point. They are working it down low, and they're working it around the outside. You need all of that.
You know, one player for the Hawks that's not on the score sheet, but it's been a very evident force on the ice, is Marian Hossa. Again, the Flyers paying special attention to number 81, and for good reason. Every time he's on the ice, you'll see two or three orange jerseys around number 81. Great speed from Hossa, great determination throughout the Stanley Cup Finals, and the Flyers are trying to contain him. You got to hope that they can, if you're a Flyers fan, because of Hossa's great ability to come through in the clutch so far in this series. But look at those orange bodies, and look at the work of Marian Hossa in continuing to push forward. Four Flyers with a chance to get him here, and that allows Christopher Steen to get in alone before he just missed the net. Hossa very dangerous so far in this game. Lots of legs, lots of energy, and the Flyers are going to have to continue to do a good job on him.
Okay, we'll see what the captain of the Flyers can do for this team. We'll meet him in a moment, Mike Richards. Meanwhile, another look at Brent Sobel's goal. Key faceoff win by John Madden, and we're tied at two. Welcome back. From the day that Mike Richards became a Flyer, people in the organization spoke of his eventual greatness, and for good reason. But somewhere along the way, the luster was lost from the kid who was supposed to carry the Flyers to a Stanley Cup. As the team struggled, many questioned whether he was cut out to be the captain. But this postseason seems to have settled that matter.
He's a warrior, he's a winner. Probably the best two words you can say to describe Mike Richards.
I think the biggest thing with him is when he goes on the ice, he shows who's the leader, and the way he plays, that's leadership.
I think he competes so well every game, every practice. He's prepared to practice and play at his best at all times, and this playoffs, he's been just a workhorse.
I think this year he's really grown. I think Prong's coming in has really helped him out a lot. You know, I was injured and had a chance to sit back and just kind of take it all in, and the way he carried himself and led this team on and off the ice has been unbelievable.
Well, Mike's a natural born leader. You can see it in his eyes and his action.
It seems like the bigger the challenge, the more he responds. And it's not a rah-rah thing. It's more he goes out on the ice, and in the biggest of games, like the Olympics, like the playoffs, like a game where you're down 0-3 in the seventh game. Those are the players that you look to lead your team, and I think Mike's done an excellent job for us.
Some guys after the Olympics kind of go down, you know, they're satisfied with the goal, but Richie came back with more hunger of winning more, and the next step for him is the Stanley Cup, and he just brought his game to another level, you know, since after the Olympics.
I just remember that first game he came back against Tampa Bay, he got like 5 points, I think, that night, and that was unbelievable the way he played.
Just being in that setting and being in that atmosphere, you were able to take an awful lot away from it. I know I did, and I'm sure he did as well. And you can use things like that in your game. You can just use that experience and how you rose to the challenge and raised your game to another level. All that plays into it, and you're seeing that here in the playoffs now. He's risen his game to a whole new level and just kind of taking the team on his back offensively.
Richards drawing the inevitable comparisons to the great Bobby Clark. You see the numbers there. They are eerily similar. The question is, can Richards also lead the Flyers to a Stanley Cup? That is the big question, isn't it? We're back after this, but right now we check in again with the Daily Line. Look at the Verizon scoring summary. Keep this in mind. The Flyers haven't scored an even strength goal since the second period of game one, and the Blackhawks haven't scored a power play goal in this series. Something's got to give, don't you think?
This has been the Verizon Stanley Cup Final Intermission Report on Versus. Verizon, the network with the most 3G coverage. The Stanley Cup Final on Versus is brought to you by Bud Light, the sure sign of a good time. Here we go. And by Verizon, official wireless service provider of the NHL.
Welcome back to the NHL Stanley Cup Final on Versus, presented by GEICO, a state record crowd for hockey. 20,297, a Pennsylvania record that may last until New Year's Day at Heinz Field in Pittsburgh when Washington is there, but that's another matter. What if you're Peter Laviolette? Now, your team is down 2-0. Twice the opposition has come back and tied the game. What do you say now going into what might be the last significant period?
Well, we're okay. We've played some good hockey. We've yet to be rewarded. I mean, this is a must. I mean, this is a must third period for that man right there, Peter Laviolette, and the Philadelphia Flyers. Lots to build on. Power play has been really good. A couple power play goals. Faceoff stock, they've been dominating 64%. But The last goal by Chicago, a faceoff win by the veteran John Madden, tied it up at two.
A very quick change just 4 seconds into this period on the behalf of Chicago as they get Taves and Kane and Bufflin out there. Bufflin stashed it on back, and it's Jalmerson giving across to Campbell. They're going up against Billy Leno as well as Scott Hartnell and Danny Briere. Pass is just cut there by Jalmerson and given across to Kane. Probing for an opening into the zone, tried Bufflin for that. Bufflin played it further, but Briere is back to protect and take. Danny Briere had it rushed right away. Bufflin will try to close off, can't. Couple of players cancel, swept back in by Brian Campbell and taken by Hart.
Nice defensive play there by Dustin Bufflin.
Let's take a look at some of the action around the net with Mitchum protecting the crease.
Well, both goaltenders, very active, lots of traffic, and that's probably been the common theme, Doc. Net presence, people getting the front of the net, and at the other end, Antti Niemi. One thing that's been much more noticeable, in my opinion here, Doc, in Game 3, is that the Flyers, when they've gotten to the net, I think there were times that they got to net in the first two games of the Stanley Cup Final, but in this one, in Game 3, when there have been people there, they've been making contact a lot more in Game 3.
Another complete change of five players by the Blackhawks, and this is Hossa starting out. Hossa able to peel on further and lobbed one that went off a glove, but Braden Coburn settled that down and lobbed it as far as Sobel, and that careened away from him. Brent Sobel, punished there by Powell, bounced right off that and controlled neatly on back for Hossa to give across to Troy Brouwer.
Dustin Bufflin's made his way into the Blackhawk dressing room, Doc, which is right directly behind their bench.
Just counting again to see 13 across the way rather than 14 at that bench. Here's Giroux dangling, but he could not outsell Sobel. Then it's Giroux coming back again, twisting one, and Sobel said, I got that one too. And back ahead with it to lay it back in once again was Brouwer. Lobbed around behind. Taken on by Boland, and a little pass in the front was ragged into some trouble that time by Gagne. Dealt it around out of harm's way to Carl, and then it is lobbed on out to center. Richards had it swatted away. Follow-up, though, comes from Gagne. Gagne centered one, and unable to pull the trigger on a shot was Carter, and then a pretty healthy hit by Gagne onto Ben Eager. Lobbed on back in near Gagne, but out of play, and so the clock is stopped. Here's Carissa.
Well, guys, I caught up with Philly assistant Craig Berube, and he said turnovers killed us in the second. We need to just attack and shoot. Stop trying to make plays. Better execution through the neutral zone, and they're going to shorten the bench and continue to attack. I mean, he says you can't score if you don't shoot. Only two shots in that last 10 minutes. And a good energy, you guys, coming from the players in the hallways. I saw them head out to the ice. A lot of talking and a lot of stick pounding, so we shall see.
All right, so there's some fire down there, and you've noticed something statistically here.
Yeah. And then I think also to that point, Doc, what Carissa was talking about from Craig Berube was a couple of the times when the Flyers entered the zone, in particular the shift that we showed about Dan Carcillo cutting the middle of the ice is there. If you direct the puck towards the net, there's your first chance. And then maybe there's a rebound. And all of a sudden, there's second and third chance opportunities. So I think it's simplifying for the Philadelphia Flyers and Dustin Bufflin back on the bench for the Blackhawks.
Just two shots in the last 13 minutes for the Flyers on Antti Niemi. Briere and Hartnell power play goals answered by Keith and Sobel. This one is knifed down and fed off the stick of Leno, and then another try in front, and that went off of the stick of Campbell. Another try, rattled around, and is tucked back ahead. Might be a breakaway. It is for Kane. Moves in. He scores! Patrick Kane, and the Blackhawks lead 3-2.
Well, after a missed opportunity for the Flyers, a missed hit by Billy Leno. Kimo teaming and pinches in. Ben Eager gets his puck up to Taves, and Patrick Kane ends up getting in behind Kimo teaming and he goes stick side, head up all the way, puck in a shooting position. And what that does, it keeps the goaltender honest. Is Kane gonna shoot? Is he gonna fake either way? You have more options when the puck's off to the side, and the reaction from the Blackhawk bench Kane on the board with his first of the Stanley Cup Final. A goal and assist here in Game 3. But a great chance for the Flyers, Doc. And then Kane gets in behind Niemann and gives the Hawks a one-goal lead.
This is Giroux flipping one in front. Oh, the rebound! Score!
Later, watch the stop by Antiniemi. Right there, it goes off of the defender in front. I believe that's Jordan Hendry. And then Billy Leno comes up with a big goal by the Flyers. We talked about Antiniemi, Doc, in this game. He's kicked out some rebounds into the high traffic area. But just getting the puck towards the net, to the point of Craig Berube, assistant coach of the Flyers, telling Carissa Thompson, even if you just get it towards the net, Doc, something good might happen. Goes off of Hendry, big rebound, Flyers get tied up.
Gagne is out there twisting one in front, and Niemi blocked that redirection by Carter, and the Blackhawks have iced the puck. Bob Harwin downstairs.
Well, Doc, I think in terms of Billy Leno's teammate, Claude Giroux, it has to do with being patient and being willing to create. When I talked to him about not having shots in the first two games and not winning faceoffs, he said, basics are my life right now. I've got to think for a second and see what I've got offensively. Beyond just the play that he helped set up, he's been smart and safe with the puck in the offensive zone with an air on the side of creating. He's looked to see what his options have been, and the flow is coming back for a very talented player.
Mike Richards, Bob, thank you very much. Breaking his stick off that attempted faceoff. Just get the puck to the net. Simplification. And Claude Giroux, a couple of assists for him here in Game 3 tonight.
Carter trying to trickle it toward the net. Shoulder into him by Sopel. It's fed out in front by Bolin and rattled off Niemi and had to be lifted on the bounce and is kept alive by Covert. Shuttled right back and out to center where they must drop back. Shift change quickly by the Hawks. 3:50 played, third period. A 3-3 tie. The Flyers have had 2-1 goal leads. The Blackhawks have had one. But in each case, it's been evened up. Again. Carried back ahead now as the Let's Go Flyers chant begins and offside is called. Tonight at 11, don't miss an all-new daily line on Versus. Liam has all the stories you need to know, including breakdowns of tonight's Stanley Cup Final. Rob has all the picks and Reese has all the punchlines. Right now, you can log on to Jen's web show and chat with her live only at Versus.com. The daily line, live tonight at 11 after the game on Versus.
The fourth line of the Flyers for Peter Laviolette, Powell, Betts, and Ian LaPerriere out there against Joel Quenneville's line of Taze, Kane, and Buffalo.
It is Betts after this one. That escapes, but right near Powell. Powell can brush it on back further. Carl, a shot blocked by Niemi, who came way out.
He wasn't so sure on that shot, Doc.
He was not, was he? Kane brings it on. Hands on to Buffalo. And that one ricocheted out of play. No penalty coming from that. Well, he has been so sure-handed that an occasional fluff and maybe a string of them starts to happen.
The Flyers just getting pucks to the net. If that puck was redirected or not, I don't believe it was redirected in front of the net. A shot from Matt Carl, Darryl Powell in front of the net. And as players, you sense that. You feel that. And I know the Blackhawks felt that with Michael Layton in game one, that he was fighting a lot of the pucks. And you go to school and never turn down an opportunity to get the puck to the net.
And what a grab by Niemi on one of those tries to the net by Richards.
Up high by Mike Richards.
Tonight's Pizza Hut favorite matchup is this one. It's one everyone expected.
Probably could line those pizzas up, Doc, and say there's probably about four or five of those matchups that have been going on all night long. But Dustin Byfuglien, his numbers, and Chris Pronger. Talk about those matchups on the back end, especially Matt Carl and Chris Pronger out there against that big line.
Byfuglien 6'4", 257. Chris Pronger 6'6", 214. Not required that you be that large to play this sport. But as Bobby Clark, the one-time general manager, said, you cannot teach size. This is fed across. Oh, and what a shot by Hossa that was answered by the pad of Layton.
Beautiful play and an outstanding stop.
Knifed away by Sopel, protected by Coburn and sent on out. Chalmerson with a denial on Briere. Off Briere, butt to Carl, away from Leno and patrolling as Sopel. Another change for the Flyers. Another change for Chicago. Back in it comes. A drive was dug by Thomas Kopetsky. Meanwhile, it's played by Matt Carl ahead and reached and sent on by Carter trying to escape. And he does, and his shot was stopped by Niemi. Another try, and that went around behind. Carl sent it further. Rattled on around near Gagne. Moves in with Kopetsky, but the latter prevailed to get it to center, and it's touched back across by Pronger. Marched back in by Carl. Took the obligatory hit from Seabrook. Keith is stepped into by Carter, and Carter is able to take it away. And a shot was knocked down. And then played on back to Carl again. Through. Oh, and a shot line by Gagne. Great setup there. Spontaneous play. Carl across Pronger. A shot held by Niemi. A little swat on him by Carter. But play stopped.
Boy, he's found his game in the last 2 minutes, Antti Niemi.
Big challenge came from him. Standing ovation here. A 3-3 tie. Oh, my. Game presented tonight on Versus by Geico. Extra equipment, extra responsibility for these guys.
Well, Antti Niemi, the last 10 or 12 seconds. A giveaway by Duncan Keith. There's a chance by Jeff Carter. Giveaway again. Matt Carl to Simon Gagne. A chance, and a Chris Pronger at the end. Maybe even redirected by Jeff Carter. They talked about Antti Niemi a little bit before that, Doc, fighting a few shots, not seeing him. Boy, he's regained his composure in the last minute and a half or so.
No icing on this. John Madden did touch it. Down it goes, and Kane is run into there by Pronger without a helmet now. Outletted pass was behind Billy Leno. Flexed on off of Hendry and turned on back. Kane still out there without a helmet. Very deliberately bashed back in by Pronger and wide. Hopped on now for Sokol. Off the board for Kane. And then Taves. Taves brings it on now. Dustin Byfuglien tried to fight by, could not. Good stop there by Leno and walks it right back. Billy Leno threw one in front and it skittered wide as breaking to the net was Giroux. Flipped on by Verstegen, kept alive there for a quick shot that's knifed down on the try by Carter. Hustling back to center, big Dustin Byfuglien wheels on in. Byfuglien has to regain possession around behind, wedged off there by Timonen, escapes and plays further. Onto the back for a throw that went just wide of David Boland and the net. Boland is run into, but got it worked along further. Troy Brouwer turns to the outside now. Brouwer spins one around that went away from the reach of Boland. Dumped on further. Versteeg reaching in. Came on to Boland. Blocked by the defense. Trickled on through. Shuffled away by Layton. Kopetsky there working. Good forechecking done here by the Blackhawks. They've caused the Flyers to turn it over. Down to the ice goes Versteeg and the puck winds up underneath. They have to continue to play and it came away from Kopetsky. Oh, and a drive by Boland that went off Layton and all the way back down. Briere rushing back and so also is Duncan Keith. Keith got there to shuffle it around now to Seabrook. 8 minutes played, third period, game tied. Taken along now by Hossa, knife neatly away from him by Carl. Hossa sweeps on back with it now, dragging through traffic and a shot went off Ben Eager and wide. Eager stood in there, he and Scott Hartnell. And then it's played by the Flyers and given back a hit for Carl. Nudged back on yet again and a steal of the puck by Hossa from Briere. No icing here. Carl pursued by Eager. Up the boards, John Madden forces it deeper. Some pretty effective forechecking being done here by Chicago.
And the shifts have gotten a lot shorter, Doc, for both teams.
Chalmers. Jalmerson with that one, and it ricocheted off Blair Betts. Jalmerson with another try this time. This one went a little better for him, though it is down the ice and will go for an icing. Offensive zone faceoff for Philadelphia.
Well, we talked about the battle between Chris Pronger and Dustin Bufflin on this shift. It's Patrick Kane first in, going to touch that puck, and Chris Pronger knocks the helmet off the head of Patrick Kane. He was trying to help or try to absorb that big hit by Pronger. It's the second hit, Doc, that we've seen by a Flyer take the helmet off of a Blackhawk player. Last one was Chris Versteeg. Should have been a penalty on Hartnell. But major collisions all over the ice.
This is played along. Turnaround shot went across the net mouth wide. And dealt back in by Thiemann and gotten by Leno again. Nice defensive work by Chalmerson, but coming along to work in deep is Jonathan Toews. Giroux reaching that. Powell trying to kick it further. Kane came by but couldn't get the puck. Instead, it's held there by Leno. Turns there trying to escape the reach of Campbell. Gave it on to Thiemann. Thiemann rushing around behind. Looks and threw one that's knifed into the glove of Niemi. Oh, my.
Well, defensemen getting active, Doc. Both these teams. Watch the play. Stop it here. Look at the play by Timo Thiemann jumping in from his blue line position. When you get defensemen involved, it opens up ice. You're trying to cause confusion. And then Thiemann just fires the puck to the front of the net. Antti Niemi with a quick stop. Is a forward in your own zone. Your responsibility is that defenseman. If you're a right winger, your man is a lefty. Thiemann recognized some space and jumped into the play to create that chance.
Richards clean win back to Pronger. Dealt along further, and it's Duncan Keith with it. Harassed there by Carter. Slithered a pass that Madden can give ahead. Versteeg played it back in and went right in after it. Coming across, though, is Matt Carl to play it for the Flyers. Flyers 3, Blackhawks 3. This one collared at center by Boland and helped on back to Seabrook. Gagne and Carter and Richards, the big line for the Flyers out there right now. David Boland holds and blasted one that rattled off the glass. Gagne dropped it back further. Carl has stood in two there and tied up enough by Kopetsky. Gagne flipped one that went off the glove of Danny Briere in a shift change for the Flyers. Grabbed off there by Keith, but he couldn't finesse it through to Kopetsky, who was coming for a change himself. Coburn with a blast that's high and wide and bounced onto Keith again. Finding energy from somewhere, these players at this point. Taken along now by Hartnell. Skipped on back for Thiemann. Thiemann dropped it back onto Hartnell again. Hartnell's pass deflected across, but Thiemann takes it. Works it back across. It went away from Leno. Gotten by Briere. Fed back off a stick to Leno. Leno twisted a pass, and it went off Hartnell. And he throws his head back in disgust as it came to center. 9.25 to go in the third. The Flyers by a shot. The game tied. Thiemann lobbed it in. Scooped up on the bounce and covered by Niemi. The city of brotherly love. Lighted up brightly tonight. It's a hockey night. Why not? And the game is tied.
Tied 3-3 on the Geico scoreboard. I'm Bill Patrick, ahead on Hockey Central, presented by Bud Light. Keith and Brian join me once again. We'll have complete post-game coverage, including highlights, analysis, and reactions from inside both locker rooms. That's ahead after the game, followed by the Daily Line. Doc?
Commissioner Gary Bettman, his wife Michelle, happy birthday to the commissioner today. Sharing a birthday with Lou Nanny, Larry Robinson, Charlie Huddy, Marty McGinnis, Russ Cortland. Kept alive now and played back in by the Flyers as we're down to 9 minutes to go, third period. Down to the ice and just now getting up to make a play as Leno. Around it came to Giroux. Giroux turns and then is forced off. Great defensive job done on him by Matt. And it's back to Carl and a shot knocked down by Seabrook. Stashed off Boland and reversed on back by Versteeg, but into trouble. Giroux fed one. Came all the way back to Carl. Led across to Pronger. Pronger then to Carl once more. Then Pronger with a drive. Deflected. It went wide. Did not look like Leno, Niemi could see that one very well. Played on now to Billy Leno, who probably could see it very well. Shouldered by John Madden. Led across to Giroux. Waits and blasts one. Saved Niemi. Cleared on back. Another shot. Oh, and he got a glove on that one from Coburn. Toews sent it along and got it out to center so they could make a change. Oh, did the Blackhawk goaltender stand up tall on those two? And play is stopped as the puck was out of play.
What a couple of stops by Antti Niemi. Claude Giroux with a great chance and then a glove save. And from our Jack Daniels goal cam, a little bit of help from the defense as well. But that all started, Doc, on the faceoff, where the Philadelphia Flyers decide, instead of trying to win the faceoff back, they went ahead on the faceoff. John Madden was anticipating the Flyers to try to win it back, but Claude Giroux tried to chip the puck ahead. And then the Flyers with a couple of great chances. And it was Billy Lano, Doc, who made the great play at the blue line to get the puck over to Giroux. And what a stop with the left pad or the left toe of Niemi.
Since Patrick Kane's goal, the shots are 11-1 Philadelphia. It went the other way after the Philadelphia goal. Chicago was getting all of their shots. Sent around for a turnaround shot, geared away by Niemi. Drug behind, and it's Richards passing back, and Carter with a shot that pinballed across. It went off Hossa, dragged on by Bufflin, played to Hossa, through to Bufflin, can't get the backhander away, shoved down by Carter. Hossa run into by Carl. Bufflin trying to get back up to play, but cannot, sealed there against the wall by Carter. And so play is stopped. There'll be a faceoff to occur near Layton.
Continue to talk about how important block shots are. Carter gets his shot blocked. A little give and go with Bufflin and Hossa. What a pass there by Marian Hossa. Chris Pronger came over to help Jeff Carter. Not allowed Dustin Bufflin to get open. And if Bufflin, I think, loses his edge, Doc, when the stick of Carter comes down, it probably would have been a penalty. But Bufflin did not. He came down eventually after they came together physically. But what a play there by Hossa. Blocked his shot. Beautiful little give and go. And how about the pass on the back end to allow Bufflin that opportunity?
Long toss ahead, laid back in by Leno and taken by Duncan Keith. Help must come this time from Troy Brower. Lifted it carefully on out to center. Glove down and laid back further for Tiemann. Just a fun, remarkable game. It's not as much fun if you're a fan of one of the teams. Here's a shot by Briere, and that is held by Niemi. If you're a hockey fan, you're thrilled by this, but there's too much tension otherwise. Bud Light Impact player. You have somebody? You do.
Scotty Hartnell. Real instrumental in a lot of the good things going on offensively for the Philadelphia Flyers. You see the numbers, just having a terrific Stanley Cup final. A goal and assist tonight. Made a couple of real good defensive plays as well.
False start on the faceoff.
Well, the anticipation on a faceoff, Doc, and you're supposed to come to a complete stop. But Danny Briere never comes to a stop. The visiting centerman has to put his stick in first. But look at Briere. It's almost a continuation. So what that is like, folks, is like running in a 100-yard dash. You got to start right on the first yard, and the other guy gets a running start. That's the advantage what Briere was doing on that faceoff.
Chipped around behind. More experienced guys, and they are awarded the Stanley Cup final assignments on merit. Are the linesmen working in this game tonight, Greg Dvorsky and Pierre Rassikov. And they hustled back and worked as a team to signal an icing and another offensive zone faceoff for the Flyers.
Good hustle there by Thomas Kopetsky and Kimmo Tiemannin. And I think, Doc, in that situation, we showed that faceoff. Because we see all it takes is one faceoff, and what ends up happening? Madden wins a draw in the second period, and Sopel puts it back in the front of the net. Flyers right now, 5-2 in offensive zone faceoff. But if you're the defensive centerman in your own zone, you got to tell the linesman, hey, please make that guy stop before he comes in. He cannot continue.
Here's a feed in front that was just off of Giroux and corralled by Pronger. Dealt back in. Brent Sopel chipped it up the boards. Kept alive, though, by Carl and spun on the bounce wide. 6:10 to go. Eager lobbed it on. Swatted back in again by Burrish. Fourth line is out there for Chicago. You tend to hear them more than see them if you listen to the boards and glass. Murray's dropped it off. Forced right back along by Powell and jabbed back in by LaPerriere. This is Blair Betts taking it. Send it for LaPerriere, who cruises. Ian LaPerriere dropped it off to Powell. Powell defended away by John Madden. Boy, he's been perfect on defense tonight, hasn't he? Plus assisting on the goal.
And on the right side of the puck, he knows where to put himself, Doc. That experience, a couple Stanley Cups in New Jersey. Always putting himself in between the puck or his man and his own goal. Never going to go wrong there, being on the defensive side in your own zone.
Long touch ahead by Boland. Sent by Carl along to Pronger. Intercepted by Versteeg. Couldn't get to the front. Boy, was he stepped into there. By the captain, Richards, a drive, and that one ricocheted off the defense and started right back out again by Richards. Richards met by Boland, just swirls on back to get a measure of control by handing on for Pronger and Carl, and then Richards again. Jeff Carter lugs this one ahead. Pass is gotten by Gagne, and a shot was blocked away by Niemi. Lobbed on further, but into some traffic, and so it's Versteeg settling things down for Chicago. 4 3/4 minutes to go in the third period. Lifted in by Versteeg, collared there, and thrown around behind by Coburn for Timonen. No 5-minute overtimes in the playoffs. No shootouts in the playoffs. 20-minute periods and all night if it's necessary. Chopped on further, and the bouncer came to center. Flagged down there and steered right back in, well wide by Coburn, but they can get a change made defensively, and that's what they wanted.
Well, he's had two back-to-back terrific games, grading Coburn back.
A stick is broken. Leno feeds it, got it himself across the Briere, dragged it, couldn't get the shot through. Campbell had stood in front of the goaltender, Niemi, and it wouldn't go.
Yeah, it was the stick of Nicholas Jalmerson. What a play by Billy Leno, and unbelievable patience there by Danny Briere. He did everything right except elevate the puck over Niemi.
Here is Kane moving in. Kane crosses and shot one that bounced off the defense and can be played along by Pronger. Sofel trying to keep his run into by Powell, and it's drifted back ahead up the wing for Aaron Asham. Asham toes it up and circles with it. Asham dropped it to the corner. Carl well in to play that, but that one careened on back, and coming way out of his goal is Michael Layton. Layton able to steer it behind, out of harm's way to Coburn, but it went off the stick of Bufflin, who jostled him out of the way. Puck back to Bufflin, fed one that handcuffed Seabrook, got it back to Campbell, dealt back away from Kane, and lifted along by Powell. Chip change, Bufflin coming to the bench, and it's settled down now by Kopetsky. Off of Kane's stick, but he's able to regather. A little over 3 minutes to go. Kane goes down, puck taken by Timonen, and Timonen able to get it back out as far as center. Another change for the Flyers, drilled back in by Seabrook. Timonen still out there. It went by him, tumbling down to the ice that time, getting back up as Versteeg. Long pass ahead, ricocheted off Gagne. Gagne stood in two by Seabrook, and good body position for the play by Keith that is ahead now to Versteeg, looking over his options as players move in that have the friendly jersey. Versteeg tried to play it again, and that skittered around behind. Set up there, they've got Keith in front. He tried to pull the trigger on the shot, but a couple of Flyers were in the way of that. Madden played it along. Sofel geared it around. Boland there, stood up by Carl, and it's taken right away, but just that quickly, Madden is able to come up with it for Chicago. Then back over to Hossa, and a shot was knocked down. Madden with it again, twirled it around behind. Boland up with it there. Boland fed, Keith a drive, pad stop made by Layton. 2:10 to go, third period. Icing is called against the Flyers.
Great shift. Outstanding work. They got some tired players on the ice for the Flyers. Peter Laviolette still has that timeout in his back pocket. And there's that play by Danny Briere after the broken stick by Nicholas Jalmerson. This is overtime minutes right here late in the third, Doc. You got some tired players. You got to exercise your option to use that timeout.
Exactly what happened. You know, you consider the Blackhawks started on the 2nd of October in Finland. The Flyers started their season in Raleigh. The Flyers made a coaching change before Christmas. The Blackhawks had the division lead from November on. Then there was an Olympic break. Then down the stretch, the Flyers get into the playoffs the last day of the season. There's no question in Chicago they're going to win the division. How are the playoffs going to go? they've gone really well, and they have for the Flyers too. And it's a tribute to the athletes how they're still standing and playing so artistically and with such effectiveness after such a long year at the best time of the year for all of us to watch. Okay, Taves on the draw with Richards. Going to try to pull it back, Taves.
Yeah, either try to get it right back or get it to Kane.
He got it back. It's to Seabrook. Across now to Keith, and the shot went wide. Bounced over for Bufflin. Reversed it on for Taves. Reached by Pronger, though. Taves all over him. Squirted free, and it is Gagne trying to play it through. Pronger looked tired on that, and he's coming to the bench now as the drag and the shot by Carter did not work. In the midst of a change now, they've got it completed, the Flyers do. It's Kane handing on, dancing back in as Keith drops to Kane, and the shot plopped up high. A scramble there, and it went wide. Played around behind, and Kane is there, and then Tiemannin. Tiemannin dumped it up the board, poked loose off the glove of Keith. The Blackhawks can't take that, or it's a hand pass. And finally, the officials tire up.
The Stanley Cup Final on Versus is brought to you by E-Trade and by Pizza Hut. Get any pizza, any size, any crust, and any toppings for one low price.
Offensive zone faceoff for Chicago. Sharp to take the draw. Against Giroux, won it to Chalmerson, played it through Troy Brouwer. Hartnell after it for the Flyers, and Sharp reached in after jostling with him, and the puck went all the way back down where Niemi will watch it and keep play alive by swinging it back over to Chalmerson. Tipped ahead now, and Sharp. Sharp spun it across. Hosa could not get by Leno's checking.
Almost.
Right back comes Hartnell again. Hartnell watched carefully by Sopel. Good convergence there by Brouwer and Sopel, and Brouwer is able to nudge it across for the carry back out by Sharp. 52 seconds separating these two teams from OT. Leno with it. Swung it back in again. Stopped there by Niemi. Left into trouble, but then it's poked aside. Dangerous lead by Antti Niemi. Right back up comes Boland with it. Hands it on a cross. Versteeg backhanded one. Went off a leg. Versteeg again. Drags. Teeth a shot. Fought off by Layton as he stood tall and had it hit his chest. Kept alive by Versteeg again. Versteeg a shot and it skittered off the defense and went wide. Wrap around attempt fails from Kopetsky. It's held back behind the net by the glove of Layton.
Well, what a pass by Chris Versteeg. Looked like he had a chance, Doc, to take the puck to the net. There's that last opportunity with Thomas Kopetsky, the shot by Chris Versteeg. Turnover by the Flyers, and here, Chris Versteeg, the dunk to Keith from about 35 feet out. Just save for Michael Layton.
Last time, Taves won this one back to Seabrook. Off this tie-up, though, it's the Flyers who poke it to the corner. Pronger hacked it along further in the last 10. Skipped on back, and Keith goes to get it. All the way down, no icing. These two teams are going to go to overtime, but here's Tate jamming one in front. And Carl obviously misplayed that. He thought it was going to be an icing, but we have noticed it was being waved off.
I think the linesman felt that Chris Pronger dummied this play, Doc, where he had a chance to touch this puck right there. They wave it off. Taves looks at the linesman. Heads up play there by Taves. And Matt Carl thought it was icing. He thought it was an icing call and chipped the puck to Taves. We're going overtime, Doc.
Well, all right. Stay tuned for the Stanley Cup Final Overtime Intermission Report. Bill Keith and Brian after the break.
Stanley Cup Final Hockey Central on Versus is presented by Bud Light, the sure sign of a good time. Here we go.
And
And welcome, everybody, to this overtime edition of Hockey Central, presented by Bud Light, as we welcome you back inside the Wachovia Center here in Philadelphia. 3-3, your score. Bill Patrick, Keith Jones, and Brian Engblom here for the first time in 2 years in the Stanley Cup Final. We head to an extra period. Let's show you how we got to this point. Kate Smith, always here in Philadelphia. The fans entering the arena, hoping to pull the Flyers back into this series. Never say die, yeah. Well, we saw that against Boston, didn't we?
Yeah, and the Flyers' power play gets the scoring started in the first period. Watch the play by Scott Hartnell. A great behind-the-back pass to Danny Briere. Briere's got his 11th of the playoffs because of that feed from Scott Hartnell. It's 1-0 Philadelphia after one.
Then the second period, the defenseman for the Chicago Blackhawks will start to get involved to get the puck back to the point. Kane will get it back to Duncan Keith. He pulls and fires. That is a beautiful shot. That ties it up at 1-1 in the second. Still in the second period. The Flyers pressing. It's on a power play. Number 19, Scott Hartnell with the redirection there. Yes, it did go over the goal line. We went for a minute and 40 seconds and came back and looked at it again. Yeah, that was over. That was credited to Hartnell. That made it 2-1. The place goes crazy. The bench is nuts for the Philadelphia Flyers. Still in the second period, John Madden with a good face-off win back to Brent Sopel. First goal of the playoffs for Sopel, and it's tied up 2-2 after two.
Third period, the Blackhawks trying to go up 3-0 in the series. They get the lead here on a beautiful goal by Patrick Kane. The wrist shot right there, his 8th of the playoffs, first of the series, but the Flyers come right back. Ville Leino out with Claude Giroux and Aaron Astrom, and it pays dividends. Ville Leino picks up goal number 6 in the playoffs, and it's a 3-3 tie as we head to overtime.
Leino with 6 goals, tying a Flyers rookie record for the most goals in one postseason. The record held previously by Mel Bridgman back in 1976. All right, let's check in with our Geico insider, Carissa Thompson, who is with the captain, Mike Richards.
Thank you, Bill. Well, Mike, the good news is you guys had a ton of scoring chances. You got a lot of time in the offensive zone. How do you close this thing out?
Do the same thing we did in the third. Keep getting pucks to the net. We want to get pucks in deep. We don't want to turn the puck over. And any chance we can get, we just, you know, bat away at the in front of the net.
When you head into overtime and you're down 2 games in a series in the finals like this, how much a mental aspect is it to keep your head in this game?
Well, I mean, we have confidence. We've done this before, but at the same time, we want to get pucks into the net. We want to be sure on every play. We don't want to make any soft plays, and obviously a big overtime for us.
What's the message in the locker room right now?
Just be composed. Don't throw pucks away. Help each other out by talking a lot, and just have confidence in yourself to make plays.
Thanks for the time, Mike. Bill?
All right, Carissa, thank you so much. Another look at the goal by the rookie Leino, tying the score at 3 apiece, and that's why we're headed to overtime. We'll be back to break it all down after this. And welcome back, everybody. 3-3 the score. We're headed to overtime for the first time in this Stanley Cup Final Series. Before the game began, we spoke of the most productive line for the Philadelphia Flyers: Scott Hartnell, Danny Briere, and Ville Leino. And there you see their numbers. And if it seems like Ville Leino was all over the ice, Jonesy, it's because he was.
He's in the middle of that graphic, and he's been in the middle of everything for the Flyers. Not only with his line mates Briere and Hartnell, he's played on the power play with Gagne and Mike Richards, creating a ton of scoring chances in the second period. He's been a wizard with the puck. Richards just missing an empty net there. Third period, no Dan Carcillo ice time. Lots more for Ville Leino. Double shifting with Claude Giroux and Aaron Asham, and for good reason. He's been physical. He's been skilled with the puck, and he picks up the game-tying goal there with an assist for Giroux. Leino has been terrific. Not many guys get away from the Red Wings. Ville Leino's one that snuck away and has found a home here in Philadelphia and has done an extremely good job. Peter Laviolette, a lot of credit, though, giving him that extended ice time. He's jumped in there and created a ton of offense.
And Brian, for Chicago, Patrick Kane came into this game with a big fat zero, a goose egg, but we knew that wouldn't last forever.
No, that's for sure. He's got way too much talent for that. In the first two games, he was very ineffective for long stretches, spent too much time checking. That's not his forte. In this game, Patrick Kane is starting to show up again. He had a chance early on. If not for a great play by Pronger coming back, that one might have ended up in the back of the net. This one, he's got his head up. He's cool and calm like he always is. Got it back to the point. That was his assist. Then this is his break breakaway, a beautiful pass from his center iceman, Tave, and he made no mistake. He is looking like the Patrick Kane that we're used to seeing. He hangs on to the puck when there's a lot of traffic. He dangles around. He does a lot of fly fishing with that puck. He just kind of pulls it out here, pulls it back, waits for somebody to come to, and throws it to open spaces. Patrick Kane has got his game back right now, and Philadelphia Flyers are going to have to keep track of him.
Who's going to be the hero tonight? We have no idea. No player in this game has ever scored an overtime goal in a cup final game. 3-3 as we head to overtime in game three in Philadelphia.
Stanley Cup Final Hockey Central on Versus is presented by Bud Light, the sure sign of a good time. Here we go. Tonight's Stanley Cup Final Overtime is presented by Las Vegas. When the clock ends, the party begins. Only Vegas. Overtime guaranteed.
Do we ever get a bonus tonight? A well-played, wonderful game is going to take at least a fourth period. Is it your thought, Mr. Olczyk, having seen a number of these, that this will go for a while or not?
I think with the way both these teams play, Doc, the mindset of Joel Quenneville, head coach of the Blackhawks, and Peter Laviolette, the head coach of the Flyers, they'd like to play a push-the-pace type of game. Certainly a must-win for the Philadelphia Flyers, but I don't see this going very long. And when I talk about very long, you know, more than maybe 10 minutes in this first overtime.
Based on what you have seen from this game, do you have somebody you'd pick to score an overtime winner for both teams?
I agree with Jones. I think Ville Leino has been just terrific. He's made a couple of great plays along the boards, not only physically, but also with his ability to be able to make plays and skill-wise. He scored that big goal 20 seconds later after Kane scored on the breakaway. I like Leino a lot. And Marian Hossa has had some opportunities, Doc. He's got four shots on goal. He had an OT winner earlier in the playoffs against the Nashville Predators. Hossa's been a guy where the puck has found him as he's entering the offensive zone. So I look to those two guys to be right in the middle of something good for their particular teams.
Nothing much at stake here for the local fans, is there? If the Blackhawks take this, they're up 3-0 in the series. And in a final series, it's been since the World War II that any ever fell. Bob Harwood.
Well, Doc Eddie's talking about Marian Hossa being involved offensively. Joel Quenneville would attest to the fact that he's so solid defensively. You've said the word stripped his player of the puck three or four times tonight. You're talking about what he does at center ice. Quenneville said he's one of the best in the league at reading the back check responsibilities and then winning the battles. Strong as a horse. I've got to believe some of that mindset comes from a year in Detroit where they did that as a living.
Indeed, and successfully. You saw the men who have scored overtime Stanley Cup playoff winners before. Might be one of them. Danny Briere has done it a couple of times, filtered it on through. Gagne to the outside, or check that, Leino. Then around for Briere again, but the bouncer is corralled and started on by Brian Campbell.
And also, Doc, remember, this overtime changes, long changes.
Richards can't get the shot away. The Flyers in the midst of a change. The Blackhawks are making one now as they get Kane and Bufflin off. Taves will go eventually. He played this one ahead, and it's laid across by Ville Leino. Taves remaining out right now with Kopetsky and Versteeg. Back down this one comes for a play that I think was going to be an icing. At least that's what Hjalmarsson thought. But they've gotten fooled, these defensemen, a couple of times tonight. Laid back in by Campbell. Jabbed along by Versteeg, and then he stepped in too, but spun off and got the pass ahead for Kopetsky. Pretty well defended there, though. It's off his stick and started back out by Carter. Punched right back through him, though, and settled down for a little pass on for David Boland. Boland defended by Mike Richards. Boland able to turn to the outside, fed it on back. Versteeg, a shot! Oh, and it was up over the net against the glass. Great opportunity that time. Here's Versteeg again, a shot that's blocked away. Pinching back in now as Keith took the hit, skittered it along the boards, but it is dropped angrily back across by Richards. Poked back further, settled down by Boland. Boland protects, got it back to Seabrook, worked to the outside again for another try that is held by Layton and knocked down, and still down on the ice is Versteeg, who has been all over the place tonight.
Boy, a couple of great chances, but it all started by Dave Boland. Watch the right part of your screen. Boland has it. There's Brent Seabrook was jumping into the play. Boland did not see him. He was wide open for a good 2 or 3 seconds. And Versteeg gets the pass from Boland. Airmails the first one and then gets another opportunity. And Michael Layton does not give up a rebound. But it all started with the initial forecheck and a long shift there for the Richards line.
To the corner it goes. Hossa is up with it there. Laid back along further by Brown. Sharp in a duel. Two aside half forwards. Giroux across and it went off of Carl, who recovers. That one is blocked off quickly though by Brower and laid on back further by Hossa to Chalmerson. Brent Sopel turning with it there. Has scored a goal in this game tonight. Gave it back across to Chalmerson. Angled near Powell. Blackhawks with another change. Laid on through and flexed down by Powell. He and Chalmerson go after it. Powell put it off the back of the cage. No harm there. Lobbed on out again by Jonathan Toews. He's got Bufflin out there with him and Patrick Kane. Billy Leno and Daniel Briere are among the forwards right now for the Flyers, joined by Scott Hartnell. Teeming in back on defense, along with the big defenseman out of the Atlanta Thrashers organization, Braden Coburn. What a trade they made to get him here, and he has been a great performer in this game and the previous one. So it's Seabrook. Keith turns away. Seabrook has it again. Kane able to get by one. Patrick Kane drifts to the outside with it. Through one that was directed well wide and hopped onto Seabrook. Chipped through him, but he recovered. Lost to Hartnell. 3:20 played in the sudden death overtime period. Hartnell trying to shuffle his way by. Defended off by Keith. Came along for Duncan Keith. Found a little room there to give it on to Seabrook. Seabrook's pass on the money for John Madden. Defensive-minded centerman brought it ahead. Laid a little pass that was cut off by LaPerriere and started on back for Briere. Shoved off his stick by Chalmerson. The two go after it. Hooked along by Campbell. Directed further by Bufflin. Kept alive for a little pass in front that's flagged down there by Campbell. Laid back down the ice, and it may go for an icing, but here comes Ben Eager after it, and he was able to cut the icing off. Played back further now by Burrish around behind. And it is pitched back on. The bouncer is settled down again by the Blackhawks, and now we get a halt to play. See that again. I'm not sure if Eager got it. I thought he initially outreached, but let's see.
It looked like he went for it, Doc, and he missed it. Chris Pronger went over the top of the puck. Outstanding job by the officiating crew. Linesman Greg Dvorsky right on that call. Sometimes a linesman referee could almost be sold by the attempt, Doc, of Chris Pronger, but great positioning, taking the right call.
Keith, a shot that is steered away by Layton. The first 4 1/4 have been played here in the overtime period. Carried back ahead by Coburn again. A drive, and that one deflected up high and out of play.
The majority of the play, Doc, has been in the Flyers' zone. Well, the Flyers, not foreign territory. Game 3 against the New Jersey Devils in round 1, Daniel Carcillo. And then in round 2, to keep their season alive, Simone Gagné in game 4, down 0-3 in the series. Gagné the winner. Here they are in overtime here in game 3 in the Stanley Cup Final.
Chris Versteeg brings it ahead. Able to take it right back again from Giroux's reach. Gave it across to Boland. Angled one stiffly. Pat Versteeg hoisted it off there by Coburn. And the puck back up the boards. Aaron Asham with the long toss. And that sailed out of play into the Flyers bench. Everybody seems to be okay from that one.
Scotty Hartnell was probably looking to try to catch that one. Flying down those left wing boards. But on that initial play right before that, Doc, Dave Bowen had the chance to get the puck to the net, but deferred and tried to move the puck over to Chris Versteeg. It was a little bit too hard, and then Colburn with a big hit on Versteeg. And the coaches and players, I'm sure, in between regulation and overtime, Doc, the reminders. Never a bad play to just fire it towards the net. You never know. Just get it towards the net.
Seabrook with that one. Tossed it back in. Shift length gets shorter.
A little bit, and especially, Doc, in overtime in the long change. Your bench being the farthest away from your defensive zone. Pretty simple. Change before you're tired.
A giveaway on. It's off the pipe. It is over the line. They are celebrating. The light didn't come on, and there's no signal. A conference. And before they even get to the scorer's table, we get to see something here from up above.
Across the goal line, never crosses the line. The puck eventually goes into the net. It was a simple play, Doc. A simple play by the Flyers. Just direct the puck towards the net. Here's Chris Pronger. He's looking for a long outlet. It goes off of Simon Gagné. Carter in on a forecheck. And it goes to Simon Gagné, and it goes off the stick of David Bolin in front of the net. Off the post, across the goal line. The Flyers think it's in, but clearly, from this look, puck never completely crosses the goal line.
They have not shown it, as they did the other one earlier, to the crowd here on the big board. And the guys down below are in contact with the folks you saw up at the top of the arena. They are just now showing one. Fans do tend to see with their hearts and not their eyes sometimes. We'll see if this is one of those cases. Here's the verdict. You are 2 for 2. The overhead camera, 2 for 2. The officials, 2 for 2. And the war room, which is inside the arena, not in Toronto, 2 for 2.
Just a simple play there, Doc. The forecheck by Carter, and then Gagné just throwing it towards the front of the net. Do not want to bypass any opportunities. How about the reaction of Antti Niemi, Doc, to not knock that puck into his own net as it's going right across the goal line?
Many are standing from this faceoff taken by Seabrook. Knifed on now for Hartnell. Hartnell with a feed in front and went off Boland again. Came onto the back now for Coburn's shot. Blocked down by Boland and trickled on out to center again. Passed across to Hartnell. Bashed it back in. Niemi stops it behind. Paddles it on for Duncan Keith. Up the boards, taken out of the play for Steak. Coming by was Boland wanting to jam it further. Did that. Hartnell gave it across to Coburn and a long toss. Goes wide of the kick. And icing is called.
I think the linesman and referee are going to huddle up here, Doc. I don't know if Antti Niemi got a piece of that puck on the icing call. It was originally called an icing. And I like what the linesman and the referee did. They huddled up. And they're going to change the call. There you see the puck change direction. So the faceoff, instead of coming all the way down to the Flyers zone for icing the puck, the faceoff will be at center ice. So a nice job by the officiating crew coming together, getting the right call, because on that replay, Doc, looked like it went off of Antti Niemi.
Well, it is Keith giving on to Seabrook. Kane and Taves and Bufflin are out there. Bufflin put it back in. Chris Pronger there for the Flyer defense. That ricocheted out of play. No penalty to come from that. It's off of Blackhawk, and the faceoff back out to the safety of neutral ice.
Best sequence for the Flyers in overtime after Chicago really dominated, Doc. Controlled the pace of the game in overtime. Flyers couldn't get in to the Chicago zone because Chicago's done such a good job of making good decisions, managing the puck, not giving it away. Took the Flyers a while to kind of get their skates under them here in overtime in the last probably minute and a half, 2 minutes. It's been Philadelphia.
Back ahead, Danny Briere. Briere sets up Carl. Side of the net, deflected, score!
Second period. It's the long change. Philadelphia had control of the puck. Look at the right part of your screen. Chicago's in the middle of a change. This allows Matt Carl to jump into the play, and it's almost a 2-on-0 in front of Antti Niemi and Claude Giroux, the guy we highlighted in the open of the show. But the change by the Blackhawks with Philadelphia having complete control in a neutral zone. What a redirect. Niemi gets a piece, but not enough. I don't even know if that puck hit the back of the net. And the reaction from Claude Giroux, and the Flyers win in overtime and make this series 2-1. But the change, Doc, allowed that open ice for Matt Carl to jump into the play.
Giroux sends them out to the street, elated. Philadelphia 4, Chicago 3. We'll check in with Bill Patrick, Keith Jones, Brian Engblom at Stanley Cup Final Hockey Central, presented by Bud Light.
All right, Doc, thank you indeed. Coming up on Hockey Central, presented by Bud Light, Keith and Brian will join me once more. And don't forget, after us, it's an all-new episode of The Daily Line. So plenty of post-game hockey coverage ahead on Versus. Right now, however, let's check in with Liam at The Daily Line.